And we are now entering the 25th hour of Global Transmission. I'm your host, Alex Jones. I want to just say that the entire InfoWars crew, our guest host, our guest, our crew on the ground in Philadelphia covering the DNC, have done a spectacular, exemplary, excelsior, amazing, in-depth job, especially the techs and producers with all the documentation, the research, running the cameras, running the microphones, lining up all the guests, doing everything. Amazing job to the entire crew. Just absolutely amazing. We do about, I don't know, 5 hours of broadcast a day out of these studios, and that takes a lot of preparation and focus. And then we also produce a lot of short news pieces and mini documentaries every day. So I'd say probably 7-8 hours of live and also produced content for an operation of really about 20 people working in production, 25 people. So I want to just say congratulations to the crew and also the listeners, especially who've been supporting the broadcast, spreading the word about it, our affiliates around the country. We are having the biggest sale ever in our history. And I've been saying that every few months now because we're just increasing the size of the sales, because the formula I have is just try to have the very best prices on high-quality products, be able to self-fund ourselves, and then to be able to have a smaller profit per item. But people know how to shop out there, not just support us, and they find out it really is a good deal, and then they end up, you know, not buying one, but buying two, buying three, and that it brings in more revenue so that we can get more aggressive and hire more reporters and more writers and more researchers and put Hillary for Prison banners in the sky across the country and trucks driving around and billboards and just everything else we're doing. And Darren McBreen has a great idea about trying to do a series, you know, like they have on all these different cable channels, because now the internet's so dominant, we would dominate that. And I want to get back into longer form documentary films. It's just that we've been trying to establish the news operation. Wow. If you go to drudgereport.com, there is, again, Hillary, where she does this great white shark attack deal. You know how great whites crest out of the water and they have, like, their jaws snapping, and I'm not trying to be mean. There's something very psychotic and very predatory about Hillary. Obama can come off charming and, you know, seem like a suave guy, even though, you know, he's creepy because you know what he stands for. But with Hillary, man, she is just, not just her actions, but her and Bill are like something out of the monsters. But the monsters are likable. They just look like creepazoids. I was hiking on the Greenbelt this morning, and I came across an old woman, probably her son, and his girlfriend or something. And I saw him 100 yards away coming down the path, and I got a creepy feeling. And as I got up close to them, they had super white skin. They were all dressed real weird, and I was just like, oh, devil worshipers. Just absolutely, you know, you click. Wow, these are creepy people. And Pat Riley was with me. And he was just like, ooh, did you feel that when people went by? And I was like, yeah, wow, evil. Let me tell you, I've been around Janet Reno, confronted her once when she spoke at UT from just right in the front aisle at the microphone, and she did this demonic smile and started, like, snapping her teeth. And reportedly Hillary is obsessed with her and loves her. I mean, these are demonic creatures. I mean, just go to drudgereport.com. I've got all this news proving they're evil, but just look at this thing where she does this shark. Can you guys show the cover of Jaws when we come back? Because I just thought of this, you know, where the shark's popping out of the water and it has that look. And it's not like they're just screenshotting it. She does this Joker meets the great white shark. Just ha ha! And by the way, we've got Obama saying there's no way, you know, Trump's going to win. Bet on Hillary. Well, because Google, by the way, has been caught, and they won't even change it, not even listing Donald Trump on the internet under presidential candidate. Drudge just changed his main headline, but I still want to blow this up because I want to create a meme showing Hillary Clinton cresting next to the Jaws shark and going after what's left of the Bill of Rights and Constitution. Because if you look at that face, that's the one she makes when she does this hyena laugh. By the way, that was on TBS, and so they removed it and apologized a few days ago. on Monday. So that's why I do want to play that again here in just a moment. Because if you listen to her, I was listening in a restaurant, and it was so annoying, and it wasn't even loud, that people asked me to please turn it off. Then I was listening to it over at my parents briefly with my son last night, and my mother is usually not an irritable person, and she said, what on earth? What is that? Turn it off. So I guess they used, to speak of industrial music, Skinny Puppy, to torture folks at Guantanamo Bay. I think we can replace the Skinny Puppy for torture with the hyena. Do we have the hyena queued up? Let's go ahead. Now, this is Hillary in between hyenas, and it's almost the same sound, and it's totally fake. It's a bark. Here it is. And then we will, after we play that, we will continue with the news. By the way, a lot of the crew's been in there, like, off and on 18 hours. We're going to pull this article up in a moment and talk about what Google's up to. This is emblematic of everything. We know that they've been spiking searches for Hillary for prison. We know they've been spiking searches and redirecting the searches into favorable things about Hillary. If you search Hillary crime, you get her crime bill of in the 1990s, 1994. But they've gone to a level beyond even the BBC and Der Spiegel changing the name of an Islamic attacker from Ali to David. Or even when they pledge allegiance to ISIS and scream Allah Akbar, they just say it's not Islamic because there's nothing less Islamic than ISIS. And of course, there's nothing drier than water. But now, Google will not even let you, as of still this morning, this has been going on for a day, it was identified days ago, but it's been in the news for a day, and I checked it this morning, it was still that way. You search presidential candidate, stories up on Infowars.com, with screenshots, and he's not even listed. It's Hillary, the Green Party and candidate, and then the Libertarian candidate, spoiler, Gary Johnson. Stories up on Infowars.com. Trump not listed in Google search for presidential candidates. When you scroll down, wait for it. There it is. Not listed. Now you go to Bing. Boom. He's front and center. And it's got all the other past candidates. But there it is. And I'm not saying Bing's perfect by any stretch of the imagination, but you'd expect Donald Trump to be front and center. Presidential candidate. You try to search crooked Hillary. Can't get it. You see, these should all be top searches because they are the top searches on Google off and on the last few months. Hillary for prison or will Hillary go to prison has been the number one search, but you can't find links without going 5-6 pages deep to the most popular relevant searches. Now, folks, if Google will do that, they'll do anything. And this is emblematic of they stole the primaries and the nomination from Bernie Sanders voters. Stole it. And told you in the news, yes, we met days before to decide who the winner was in places like California at a, quote, rich donor's house. But they still went ahead with the ceremonial election and then ignored it. And then just changed the numbers to what they wanted. Clinton email reveals that Hillary worked with Google CEOs to keep hashtag Benghazi video blocked. That's in the WikiLeaks emails. But see, you're not hearing about the 20,000 new WikiLeaks DNC emails and phone calls. You're just hearing, oh, Putin did it. He's so bad. Or, oh, my gosh, that said they might want to work against Bernie. Oh, Hillary was never against Bernie. She stole it from him. So now we have the, in fact, we probably should play today Let's grab some of the voicemails and play these here on air. We're not going to talk about who got the emails because we really don't know. I think it's probably the Russians. Thank God. Somebody's fighting back against this criminal group that's hijacked our nation out of self-preservation. Are you fighting back? I mean, they're trying to get street riots, killing police going. We have a foreign globalist group overthrowing the nation, like in the Red Revolution in 1917, 1918. I mean, that's what this is. But it's a globalist operation, but using communist tactics. I mean, I cannot stress to anyone the grave danger we're in when they're stealing nominations and Google won't let you search Crooked Hillary and redirects you. And then we've got Hillary emails and DNC emails with Google, who they meet with for 5 hours a week, at least, at the White House. Some weeks they meet with Google up to 4 times. And I mean Google heads. They are in there wargaming and deciding what you can see and where you can go. Like we're living in Ceausescu's Romania or Kim Jong-un's North Korea. This is trillions of light years beyond anything that we've even seen go on in North Korea with the high techness of it, and how it's just so over the top, so completely brazen. They're caught red-handed in thousands of scandals and rigging everything. And then they have another all-day hate fest, misinterpreting and misconstruing and misrepresenting and lying and spinning and obfuscating and dissembling Donald Trump. I got to tell you, though, if America lets Hillary Clinton steal the election, we deserve it. I mean, we have butchered 55 million babies, and we have let globalists do all these evil things in our name. And so guess what? What comes around goes around. You reap what you sow. The chickens are going to come home to roost, everybody. Because our men were too busy playing fantasy football. Our women were too busy acting like they're tarts while their kids are getting hooked on government-shipped-in drugs. And believe me, I'm not on some high horse. I'm just here to tell you that we make Sodom and Gomorrah and corrupt, decadent, latter Rome look like very tame societies and cultures. And I'm not even talking about so much sex or drinking. I'm talking about not caring, not taking it personal when you're enslaved, not taking it personal when you're lied to, not taking it personal when you're overrun by tyranny. The good news is people are fighting back and taking action and waking up. The problem is globalists are organizing governments, corporations, and media to go after people that are trying to bail water out of the sinking ship, because the globalists want to sink civilization in some giant funeral pyre of humanity, and then they believe out of that transcendent phoenix will rise out with this new super being. I mean, talk about a lie of the devil. Even if you don't believe in an incarnate entity, the color out of space, fallen here. I mean, yeah, it all makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? Yeah, everybody knows in their gut. And it's promising the elite, because this is what they're all into. I don't care if they're Chinese elite, Russian elite, U.S. elite, the globalist elite. This is what most of the elite are into. That they're going to become gods and transcendent and merge with machines, but that the world must fall first. And while they claim that they're doing all of this to save the planet, they're actually overriding it and killing it and then creating horrible, ugly, stinking monstrosities in its wake. Purely sake of attacking all that is good. We've got a lot of news, a lot to cover. Stay with us. What happens in history when societies become more and more corrupt the establishment will become more and more oppressive. And normally it gets pretty brazen out in the open. Now we have all these people engaging in classical psychological warfare, raising the bar on Western civilization so high with 50 different genders and all the rest of it to sow total confusion. And I was watching video that Joe Biggs and others shot at the DNC live. There's hours of it. And we weren't just picking out certain people to make the Democrats look like kooks. A good third of them are what I would describe as people that came out of the Hale Bopp cult, the Jim Jones cult, the Charlie Manson cult, mental institutions, but they weren't born mentally ill. They are totally scramble-brained, filled with hate, and have been given this whole language of gibber. One of them is on screen. You're an effing white male privilege. Silence non-binary trans people. I mean, this is just Martian gibberish. And it's all these people just hopping around. They have no futures. There is no culture. They've been totally raised on scrambled Adult Swim weaponized media to make you illogical and mentally ill. And they don't know what planet they're on. You know, I'm sad for Abe Skrilix and Carl the Cuck that we shot footage of. And that's what they're known as. So I have to use those terms because it has become one of the most famous memes probably in internet history. And we shot the footage. We did not come up with the meme, though we do supply much of the raw material for the memes. And, you know, you're hopping around screaming at people, you're an effing white male when you're an effing white male. And you say you can't listen to an effing white male white privilege. Spewing total mindless racism. And you're so arrogant and so unable to form an argument that people are going to ridicule that. But we had one of the supposed associates call up here to the office last night of the man known as Abe Skrilix. His identity's known. I'm not going to say his name. Saying, can we please fix it? But that it's the fault of the person they debated. He created the meme. No, he didn't. You said what you said. You said the illogical, bizarre, contradictory things. And you look like arrogant cartoon characters. So you've been turned into those. There's a new video out that I'm going to have posted at Infowars.com that is an animated piece with Abe Skrilix and Carl the Cuck that is the best thing I've ever seen. I mean, when it comes to really showing what these people are like, we can't play it here because there's so much cussing, but it's their words. It's their words. With voice actors that are just simply amazing. So I've got a headline for this. I'm going to tell you guys during the break, then I want to tweet it out. I want to post it to Infowars.com. It is adult, but it's just so intellectual, but also so funny at the same time. All the contradictory, illogical things that these people really say. But here's the deal. Carl the Cuck and Abe Skrilix were just being mean and virtue signaling and wanting to bully and getting off on virtue signaling to the black people. There's steps down now of what I call the Muppet zombies. And I don't say this with pleasure. A good third of these people are whacked out of their minds and not even on drugs. I've seen mind control victims. I've seen the film footage of our airmen shot down and held for years in North Korea in the Korean War and prisoners of war in Vietnam. And I'm telling you, folks, that's what high schools and colleges and all this have done to people. They take young kids and they tell them, you've been hurt, you've been bullied. Even when they haven't been, they teach them to be victims and they teach them their identity is being a whack job. Then they scramble all the terms. This is how you keep people from having families and having kids. This is weaponized systems. This is not liberal. This isn't, oh, they screwed up, they tried, they wanted to help. We have Department of Education manuals that have been reprinted in the book Deliberate Dumbing Down that I think we still sell at InfoWarsStore.com where they said 30 years ago this would finally be their plan. But after the zombie phase, I'll tell you what comes next. I'll tell you about after the zombie phase, there's a new man. Here's what's happening. They want to censor the internet, Google and all the rest of them. They want to shut down searches on Hillary and her criminal activities. They want to just say Donald Trump doesn't exist, just erasing from the presidential candidate pages. All you're doing is showing people what hardcore despots you are. And then your victims are these scramble-brained bullies that are just running around trying to intimidate everyone. But the intellectuals are using your own idiocy right back at you. And I've got to say, Joe Biggs and the rest of the crew that are on the ground in Philadelphia, I'm going to get Biggs on today, have been getting footage where I'm sitting up at night for like 2-3 hours trying to watch all this. I can't turn away because it's so horrifying. And I keep hoping maybe there'll be some people that aren't zombies. And there's like Baron Harkonnen, Jabba the Hutt creatures. I mean, the creepiest people you've ever seen on the outside. And then on the inside, they're even creepier. And you've got to understand, this is who the globalists have mobilized to bring down this country. And they've done an incredible job. I can tell you, they will not rest until every one of us is a brain-damaged fluoride head. They will not rest until it's the law. You got to give your kids high fructose corn syrup formula so they got a brain a third the size it should be, or a third smaller than it should be, to be technical. And it's just horrific. I mean, if this isn't satanic, if this isn't some devil, then it is the devil because we've created it. You understand, the devil exists. Kim Jong-un, devil exists. And notice how weak the devil is. A little toddling wimp who executes family members with mortars and just runs around with all these sycophantic people worshiping him, and his whole population is almost at starvation level. And then he is so disconnected from reality, he thinks Dennis Rodman's cool. Dennis Rodman wasn't cool 15 years ago. Super boring. Super stupid. It's just so, evil is so Twilight Zone. Evil has to import cars to North Korea and Cuba. They can't even build cars because the state doesn't want you to. It wants to rub out innovation and humanity. It's a post-industrial Jacobin Luciferian society. And I've had so many historians on, and I say, are the roots in communism the Jacobins of the French Revolution? And they go, yes, but it goes back before that to the legalists of China and to Plato. And if you haven't read The Legalist, and if you haven't read Plato, you don't know what you're dealing with. Just because you don't go out and get any sun and you've got zits all over your face, you can scream you're an effing white male, Donald Trump wants war, when Donald Trump's been anti-war. Or you say that he hates gay people when the guy was an advocate for equal rights before it was cool 30 years ago. And whether you support that or not, the point is, everything they say about Donald Trump is twisted or inverted. And that's what this comes down to. They want you to feel bad about yourself. They want you to be poisoned and ugly because they're poisoned and ugly. And guess what? We're not going to do that. And here's the thing about the human mind and psyche. If you're not aware of an attack, it will defeat you. But studies show if you're aware of an attack and resist it, it makes you stronger. I don't care if it's poison. It doesn't matter what it is. When you're aware of it and if the dose is... See, the globalists want to dose us with poison and cultural poison and literal poison and GMO and electromagnetic radiation slowly while they try to mitigate it and figure out ways to shield themselves. They're basically doing a mass test. But if we're aware of the attacks, just mentally, and drink purified water and take nutraceuticals and get sun and pray to God, every study, there's thousands of them. I mean, even atheists admit that prayer brings you to a higher level of brain activity and the whole body. When you go into that space and connect with God, the higher power, that it opens you up and is absolutely associated more than anything with defeating all sorts of diseases, you name it. That's why so many times a person's wife or husband will die and they're totally healthy and they're dead a month later because they give up the will to live. Well, we have to have the will to live. And the entire globalist program is about taking our will to live away. Telling us we're bad, telling us we're evil, telling us that we're a fallen, you know, twisted, bad group that only they can raise us up. No, God can raise us up, not the New World Order that seeks to bring us even lower. Two mysterious lights streak across the sky side by side, seen in California, Utah, Nevada. Chinese rocket test, probably. Remember they fired a missile right off the California coast a few years ago and let us know. Anti-satellite weapon. You know, they're calling it conspiracy theories when people question Irgun and the martial law. I have mainstream articles calling it a conspiracy theory. If you discuss the coup and the counter coup and how they're arresting tens of thousands of people and killing them and torturing them. And the media just doesn't want that discussed, so they call it a conspiracy theory. Oh, that's right. Again, this is just the total assault on reality. And again, you can go back to the New York Daily News. You go back to the, it's admitted that they stole the election from Bernie Sanders. They stole California. They stole New Hampshire and eight other states. Sanders was destroying her, and they wouldn't let the delegates that came that actually represented the precincts come, and they said the superdelegates will decide. And now in Turkey, Reuters says the public's questioning the government and doesn't like martial law. And so you know what they are? They're conspiracy theorists. They're protesting in the street. Conspiracy theories flourish after Turkey's failed coup. See, now just demonstrating is a conspiracy theory. I remember one time I was going to the TSA and they wanted a naked body scan me. And I said, look, I know you guys save that. And I know that it doesn't protect anybody. And I know it puts off radiation. And they lied. And the guy goes, oh, another conspiracy theorist. No, what I was saying was facts. Coming up, this is on DrudgeReport.com. It's an Infowars.com Paul Joseph Watson story. Bernie delegate, DNC, is replacing Sanders supporters with paid seat fillers to create fake unity. Well, that's exactly what the Republicans said they were going to do. But see, Trump didn't go along. He said, you're stealing it. And the media said, he's discredited now. He'll lose because he made it up. But we are going to take the votes and not count them. But still, he's a sore loser. But Trump was winning. So Trump didn't sit down and didn't shut up and then let them put the wooden man meets Count Chocula, you know, up there. Ted Cruz. He fought. He spoke out against the fraud. He won. And mark my words, he's going to win a landslide. And mark my words, Hillary is probably going to steal it in front of God and everybody else at high noon. They're going to be projecting her as the winner by 2 or 3 o'clock in the afternoon. They don't even care about the ratings. This is about taking this country down and mounting our head on the wall as a trophy. Bernie delegate, DNC is replacing. And then we've got another clip. Bernie supporter confronts seat filler. They're throwing the Bernie delegates out because, remember, they've been booing almost unanimously, like 80% of people. So they're having to kick them out. They're withdrawing their credentials because they're supposed to be there under law, under free and fair election laws. The ceremonial Republicans supposedly manage it, but you don't get to just say, well, then we don't count votes anymore. That is the crazy arrogance of these people. And you saw it in both parties because it's the same political class that's been pampered, that have infested this government and infested our nation and infested the rest of the world, that are firing people like General Flynn that are trying to stop World War III with the Russians, and who wouldn't back ISIS and Al-Qaeda, so just removed him 2 years ago. And General Flynn, who's one of the most successful commanders in the military, reorganized special forces, you name it, he came out and he said Hillary Clinton should be arrested for treason. That's the kind of stuff they'll blow his airplane up for. But he said it. So you've got people 1 inch away from a military counter coup. And I've never wanted a military counter coup because they usually go wrong and they're bad. At some point, though, there has to be a limit when they're fixing elections, openly stealing elections, openly having Google not list Donald Trump, and have the hijacked federal government trying to start a civil war financed by a bizarro Hungarian Jew Nazi sympathizer. How do you make that up? Who's 85 and looks completely insane and told newspapers he believes he's the Messiah. We have crazy people like George Soros with $25 billion we know of, probably trillions, literally, trying to overtake Russia. Look, you're no Napoleon, you're no Hitler, bro. They all thought they were a Messiah, too. At least they were military commanders and were war heroes. You are a demon. You're not even a devil, Soros. And that's why you're in this position to cause World War III. Just look at that worm on screen. Look at that sick, evil, filthy monster that you would expect to come right up out of the bowels of hell. That is Schmeagle on steroids. That is Gollum. That is a tool bag. Say what you want about Adolf Hitler, but he had the Congressional Medal of Honor. That's the Iron Cross first class and second class, and was in hundreds of battles and was a message runner through the lines and had the record surviving running through the lines and was gassed twice by German blowback of mustard gas. And then had hallucinations that he was going to save Germany and all the rest of it. A very twisted, dark, wicked guy. Napoleon, top artillery commander, military genius, thought he was God, though, thought he was invincible. Those were military men that knew what they were doing, starting wars. George Soros is a demon. And they've got a bunch of sycophantic yes men and women infesting the CIA, infesting all these agencies. Samantha Powers and these weird women on power trips with all their jewelry flapping their arms about how we're going to blow Russia up. And top generals on Fox News saying we need more dead Russians and more body bags. This is the kind of talk that just absolutely reeks of collapse and failure and thermonuclear war. Just stinks. These are stinking demons on narcissistic, crazy power trips that, oh, we're in control. Oh, we're in command. Oh, we have all these weapons. Oh, we have all these satellite-based weapons. Oh, let's use them. Oh, we've got DU Sabos in orbit. Oh, it doesn't matter if you knock Russia out. Their response will end up destroying the United States with submarines off the coast, jackass. Sure, you got 5-to-1 superiority on the Russians. It doesn't matter. The world ends. George Soros must be stopped. Hillary Clinton is obviously a complete lunatic. If you saw her in the grocery store, you'd go around the aisle to stay away from her. If you saw her, she's a creep. She's a witch. She's turned over to evil. Look at her face on Drudge. Look at it. Tonight, DNC storm warning. The heavens open up to drown the corruption. And then her, can we cue up the hyena thing again? Just running around, barking like a hyena. And then she does this thing where she opens her mouth like the Joker. I mean, all she needs is green skin, folks. These people are going to destroy us. I'm telling you. The only solace is they're going to be destroyed in it or down in their bunkers. Can you imagine being locked up with a bunch of globalists in a bunker? They're going to go completely insane. Bible says all the rich men will go into the mountains, into their armored fortresses, and beat themselves on the head, wishing God would kill them. I'm sorry. pray to God we seek repentance. I don't mean these fake whorehouse churches that try to keep you under control and all these name it and claim it demons. I mean, you just go into those churches. I mean, it's like freaking, you can see the, actually almost see the devil standing behind those people. They just, because that's where the devil sends his armies, is into those churches to neutralize it. But we should repent, because the whole world is just going to hell in a handbasket. Merkel wants to accelerate more refugees coming in as the terror attacks explode and as they declare martial law and put troops on the street. That's the plan. The death of logic. By the way, I haven't plugged in 50 minutes. We're in the 25th hour of the worldwide broadcast. We are raising a lot of money to help fund the operation with the giant discounts. I want to thank you all that have gone and gotten the products, and a lot of you trying them for the first time. 40% off on storable food, 40% off on Brain Force, just an amazing nootropic. That's $17.76, folks. Comparable formulas are $60 to $70. So it's always a great deal at $29, but now it's $17.76. Super Male Vitality, that's 30% off. I mean, just you name it. We've never had an across-the-board sale this big. We've had some that are close, but not this big. Free shipping on orders $50 or more. And, of course, you can also get 10% off additionally when you sign up for auto ship on the nutraceuticals, coffee, you name it. 20% off on water filtration, InfoWarsStore.com. We'll be back. You've got 3 hours and about 6 minutes left in the global transmission. And then this once-a-year 28-hour event will be a thing of history. Just as human life will be a thing of history if there's a full-scale nuclear war. Which even mainline analysts admit we're closer to than even back in 1961 with the Cuban Missile Crisis. It is so sad that this is all going on and unfolding. But humanity has a chance to turn it around. I'm going to open the phones up in the first half of the next hour to get your view on what's happening, to get your view on what's unfolding. The toll-free number to join us is 800-259-9231. First-time callers in the first few rounds, 800-259-9231. And I will take some of your phone calls interspersed with David Knight and Joe Biggs. And then Dinesh D'Souza's on. I'll get to some of you then. Tucker Carlson's coming on. Anthony Gucciardi is hosting the fourth hour, and I'll host part of that with him as well. I do have a lot of news to get to, obviously. This is a big story. Bernie delegates, DNC, is replacing Sanders supporters with paid seat fillers to create fake unity. The article's on InfoWars.com and the left-hand side of DrudgeReport.com. Let's go ahead and play that clip.
And I was contemplating leaving, but I'm going to stay because the convention is full now. Every seat in the House is full. So those seat fillers you guys were hearing about, it's real. They're in here now. There are a lot of people sitting near me who I don't know or have seen the entire time I was here. I've been hearing from some of you who have been contacting me by text and direct message that the media is talking about how the convention looks more unified today, that, you know, everybody's applauding in unity and chanting in unity, and it's because the Bernie people aren't here. The Bernie people aren't here, and the people that are here are getting paid to sit in their seats and clap their hands. That's what I believe. I'm not 100% sure, but that's what I believe. That's what I see with my eyes. They have the floor closed off right now for anybody who gets out of their seat to go to the bathroom, which is how this all started for me, or to do anything. If you're hungry, if you leave your seat, you can't get back in right now. And my guess is that's because a seat filler is in your seat.
That's good. The full video is up on InfoWars.com with more details. But that's everything with them is stealth. They don't just openly say it. It's all just, oh, what? We don't know. What, you're a conspiracy theorist? Well, here is a Bernie supporter confronts a seat filler. Let's play that clip.
Hey, guys. This is Nancy. I'm a whip for Bernie today. It's Wednesday. Here we have, you don't have to say your name if you don't want to. He just came down from above the nosebleed section. And because our people, the Bernie people, went out to do a press conference, he was just given a credential, right? Right? Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. And he came to get a seat filler. So this is true. Thank you so much. I love you, brother.
All right.
You can go up. There we go. There's one guy that I have on video.
admitting that he's a seat filler.
There you go. A seat filler. Of course, they're taking the delegates. They're ignoring them and creating super delegates. So everyone's trying to prove, look, they're stealing. Yes, we know. It's all admitted. They'll just call you a conspiracy theorist. By the way, the sale is going to have to end tomorrow on many items. Some of it will be extended. We have the biggest sale in our history, mega sale, to help fund the operation. Great products. Infowarsstore.com. Take advantage of it. Be part of funding the InfoWar. Tip of the spear. We'll be right back in 70 seconds. Shock poll from the LA Times. It's up on Infowars.com, also on DrudgeReport.com, LinkedIn Red. How the USC/LA Times Daybreak tracking poll works. And it is a scientific poll. And they go into the fact here that Donald Trump is now 7.8 ahead of Hillary Clinton and growing. 7.3 in some of the demographics. But what I'm getting at here is, I've been telling you that internal polling scientifically conducted by unnamed parties is showing about a 7.5. That's, I told you that a week ago, told you again, that that's really what the Trump campaign thinks they've got going. That's the real numbers. They don't want to be too optimistic or folks won't bust their butts to get out and vote. It isn't just generally about overall popular vote because of the Electoral College as well. And there is massive pull out all the stop fraud going on. But it looks like he's going to win Florida by as much as 10 points. If you see him lose Florida, you know the election was stolen. But they've already rigged the internet. They've already rigged Google. They've already rigged the primary for the Democrats. For Hillary, so you know they're going to try to steal the election. There's no way that group of reanimated corpses and zombified weirdos is actually going to win in this country. Quite frankly, unless they're young trendies, almost everybody I talk to, no matter what color they are, is supporting Trump. I mean, I see trendy liberals wearing the hats, and I go, is that a joke? And they go, no, we like him, we get it. This show is mega viral with high schoolers and college students who are really just sick of hearing about how they're an effing white male or an effing white female. And the quote, minorities are sick of it. They just want to live their lives. They're just people. It's all to get us fighting with each other. Let's talk to Monica in Montana. You're on the air.
Hi, Alex. It's awesome to be on air with you. Hey, I was listening last night, and you were talking about your heritage and where you come from. And my mom and I talk about genealogy a lot. And I found out recently that we're related to, sorry, I'm so nervous.
A lot of interesting folks. It's okay. Go ahead.
So many people. 4 presidents. John Adams. John Quincy Adams. Ulysses Grant, which I'm not really proud of that, but...
You should be proud of it. I mean, Ulysses S. Grant was a drunk and did some corrupt stuff, but he was an interesting guy.
And it is so cool, you know, and it seems as these things start unfolding before us, it's almost like our genetic code changes and the patriot inside of us. You know, we wake up and we go, we're supposed to fight this tyranny. And I am so proud to have their blood flowing in my veins.
Well, sure. I mean, all of us need to look back on our ancestors. That's our great genetic heritage. And that's what they want us to forget. But listen, it's not just that we have corrupt elites. We have elites that are anti-human. The species is threatened. That's why people are activating. People can feel it in their bones, in their gut.
No. Mm-hmm. And you just spoke to me 100% last night when you talked about, holding your children and nursing your children. And, you know, I nursed my son for 2 years. And I am absolutely proud. You just said everything that was on my mind last night, and I want to thank you so much.
Well, you're a sweetheart. Look, it's life. You've got goodwill. I've got goodwill. I want to see people successful. I want to see humanity empowered. I want to see bullies like Kim Jong-il and Kim Jong-un on the ash heap of history. And all of us transcend race or where we're from or all this stuff by the fact that we want liberty and we want freedom. And that's why to see them stoke the fires of racism on all sides is so sad, because it is a plan to bring us down. The species is under fundamental attack. Thank you, Monica. More calls straight ahead.
I
am announcing a new meme contest that is only going to be 48 hours. That way, people get it done, and then we have the prize. And it's going to be for $1,000 with the photo that's on drudgereport.com right now. We'll post it to Infowars.com of Hillary Clinton, where she's doing a great white shark emerging or cresting out of the water. And it's a cross between a great white shark and the Joker. I mean, she really is villainous, and I think it's an important meme to have the Constitution up on the top of the water, or the Bill of Rights, or America. Here she's coming. Or the Second Amendment, quite frankly. Because that's really what's going on here. So how do you illustrate her as the shark coming up with the Second Amendment? Because they're coming out with the guns. The delegates have told us we're going to get the guns. They have told us. And they're now stealing the election. And Google admits, yeah, we're not letting you see Donald Trump as a presidential candidate. He's just not listed. Think of the control and the openness. Where is the congressional investigations? I mean, it's crazy. And it's only getting worse. Meanwhile, German armed police finally smashed their way into a mosque and raid homes of a group accused of radicalizing Muslims and grooming them for jihad. Why'd you let them in to begin with? Anti-terror squad arrests passenger who launched into ISIS speech, forcing Dubai flight to make emergency landing. This is a worldwide jihad offensive. ISIS releases sick video of fanatics who butchered priests, why don't you say Islamicist, swearing loyalty to the terror group. Of course, they were telling us that was an ISIS member. Merkel admits EU is being ravaged by terror, but says Germany should welcome more refugees. The Spectator asked the question, when will our politicians accept the reality of Islamic terror? They're bringing it in. They control it. They're using it to take our liberties. Tourists banned from taking bags onto Cannes beaches in France over terrorist attack fears. See, all of you are prisoners. You can't bring a picnic. You can't bring some wine. You can't bring some water. You can't bring a bag. Because no one has rights, because your government brought these people in. I want to go to David Knight and to Joe Biggs, both to get a report from each one. First, Joe Biggs, I'm going to go back to your calls. Then Dinesh D'Souza joins us, Tucker Carlson, and more. But gentlemen, incredible job, first off, talking to Joe Biggs. Joe, incredible. You've been outside the convention mainly. You're inside now. We've seen David Knight inside witnessing it. I mean, you talk about zombified people. You have found folks more whacked out than even Abe Skrilix and Carl the Cuck and other famous people. I mean, these are like zombies that I've seen who've been through brainwashing camps. I mean, I don't know what's happened to these people. What have you experienced, Joe Biggs?
It's pretty amazing. I mean, there's been a large group of diverse people outside, to say the least. You know, you've got this Black Lives Matter group. You've got these anarchists. You have these socialists. You have just the pissed off Bernie fans who feel like they've been cheated. And with the DNC leaks, it's been proven that they have been. And they're all kind of like meeting in the middle and finding common ground. And they're massed in numbers of the thousands outside when they go out there. And last night, they were able to rip down the wall. The police had to jump in there and start shutting it down. People were arrested. The other night, I witnessed people jumping over the fence trying to get into the DNC to help support the Bernie delegates. Last night, there was a lady who was yelling, calling this guy a effing white male, and that effing white males always speak over non-binary transgendered people. I don't even know what that means. I guess that's a new
word. What it means is you're not allowed to speak. When you speak, it's evil.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
I mean, no, this is what you'd get from a whacked out person that was in some, you know, Eastern mysticism cult or something. I mean, these are wackos.
Yeah, I mean, when I saw her start speaking and she goes, camera, please, cameras, please. I'm speaking, cameras. And I'm like, who the hell are you talking to? And she would sit there and just pitch this temper tantrum and start screaming whenever someone else would talk. And all you would hear was someone being screamed like fascist or Nazi or whatever. And they use these little terms all the time.
And then she had these weird little bully guys that would come over and threaten to physically attack people. I mean, it's just, wow. These are victims, man. These are mind control victims.
Well, there's a kid. He's 19 years old. His name's Joey. He's a local. And he's been going around to all these protests. That's him right there in the white shirt, teaching people about globalism. They come over and grab him and start, like, grabbing him, pick him up.
And pushing him and threatening to attack him.
Because he went over and started trying to debate the girl and, you know, and said, you know, what's going on? This is...
And by the way, they hog all the cameras, too.
Yeah. It's definitely been interesting to see this melting pot of retards, so to say.
And, you know, we should be politically incorrect because these are the equivalent of... These are culturally lobotomized people. I mean, they are like someone who's had, you know, their brain cut into. And I mean, I laugh at it, too. There's a new epic video that went up on Infowars.com titled Abe Skrilik and Carl the Cuck Star a New Film. It is adult in nature, but it is their characters that were created by the Internet. Of course, we shot the footage. And you know, I mean, you know, they say we're effing white males or anybody else and that Western civilization is a bad thing. So we've basically tried to get into their minds. Well, I mean, we didn't produce this, but this film, I think, is a masterpiece. Have you seen it yet?
No, I have not yet. I'll have to check it out.
Well, this is a masterpiece of intellectual tour de force that I think deserves an Oscar.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Well, wait till you see it. I mean, it's unbelievable. In fact, I want to find out who these talented people are. Other points, other observations. We're going to talk to David here.
I think tonight's going to heat up again as well. You know, last night a lot of people came out. I think once Hillary Clinton takes to the stage on this historic night, so to say, historic in the fact that we found out how deep the corruption goes in the DNC and how they can completely ignore it, spin it like it's okay, and the American people will just go along with it. I think that's the historic moment right there. Not the fact that there's a woman, but the fact that these people have the curtain pulled away. They can see behind it. They can see the corruption, and they're still going, you know what? I'm okay with it. I'm with her. I'm with her.
This is absolute falling to the altar of authoritarianism, rigging everything, kicking the Bernie people out, bringing in the fake delegates, and then putting on a facade show. I think you can say more than ever, David Knight, reporting from the DNC, going back to Biggs here in a moment, that this really is the time that you can say, Toto has pulled back the curtain, and now America and the world must decide whether we're going to stay in fantasy land or save ourselves.
Yeah, Alex, you were talking earlier about creating a meme with Hillary as a shark or something. I think the meme would be something about Hillary jumping the shark and the rest of the DNC jumping the shark Hillary. That's what we've seen here this week. We've got the story, of course, by Paul Joseph Watson talking about how they're trying to fill these empty seats. Alex, inside the auditorium, we had to get out of there to get on the air because Katy Perry is rehearsing for tonight. She doesn't have her pyramids with her. She's got stars and stripes all in the background, not Illuminati eyes. So, you know, they're cleaning up their act for tonight, but they got a lot of entertainment planned. They've got a card stunt that they're going to do. They've got cards taped to each one of the seats that they're going to show at some point in time. But the substance is what's the issue, Alex. Last night, I want to read you a quote from Barack Obama's speech. He said, Hillary knows we can insist on a lawful and orderly immigration system. Can you believe that he would have the audacity to put that in there after what he has done? When we look at what's happening in Europe with this priest, you know, that is where we're headed, Alex.
Well, sure, and the Supreme Court ruled he's violating law. The law was already there. He's completing the smuggling process. They're letting people in with serious diseases. It's all confirmed. He's totally lawless. Exactly, yeah. But they're upholding the law, though, David, in fantasy land.
Yeah. You know, we know that Europe is a couple of years ahead of us in terms of the big wave of Muslim migrants from countries that we're at war with. And we just had at the end of Ramadan, about a week or so ago, we had John Kerry bragging about the fact that he had brought in six times the number of immigrants from Syria, where there's the war going on, bragging about that to a group of Muslims. And when I look at what happened in France, you know, that was a first that they don't want to talk about on the Democrat Party. Okay, that was a big first. We haven't had something like that for several hundred years in Europe, where Muslims have gone in and committed atrocities like that in a religious-based motive. But, of course, the Pope says that had nothing to do with religion. You need to understand, we all need to understand that it's a Muslim custom that when they take over an area, they always desecrate the holy sites of the other religions, and then they erect their mosques over those former sites.
The churches, yeah, that's right. The Blue Mosque in Istanbul, what's Constantinople, one of the biggest and oldest Christian churches.
Yes.
And, of course, it's now a mosque, and it's captured booty. It's cute, though. It's cultural enrichment to have your daughter sold into sex slavery, as they did more than 20,000 of the Christians' little girls. So they could be loaded onto slave ships and taken to Africa to be gang-raped in North Africa. But, again, it doesn't matter that the Muslims created the modern slave trade, because all of the mainstream media teaches black people to be Muslims, because that's how you fight the whitey.
Well, it's just amazing to me, Alex, to see the bold-faced lies that are being told by the Pope, that are being told by Obama in terms of talking about how we're going to have an orderly system. And then today he doubled down on this. You know, the whole theme this week has been, look, Donald Trump painted a very dark picture of America. Everything is just wonderful, even as we're having daily terrorist attacks going on in Europe that they don't talk about at all. But then he doubles down and he says this. He says that the idea that America is somehow on the verge of collapse, this vision of violence and chaos everywhere, where did we get that from the news that they're not talking about? Doesn't jibe with the experience of most people, but it will be our experience, Alex. We know this is going to be brought to America. We know the policies of Hillary, the policies of Obama and Kerry are the policies that are going to bring the same types of terrorism with bombs, knives, trucks to America's shores.
And we know the rest of the equation, official martial law in France, extended basically indefinitely, national police to go after people that criticize Islam. Same thing in France. The public can't have bags in public or whatever. Now, everyone's a prisoner. Martial law, but bring in more of the darling little 80% military-aged men who invaded Syria and then blame the Syrians. Everything is a lie on a lie. It's like they're playing a game where the more lies they can pack into one statement, the better. Joe Biggs, what do you make of the permanent civil emergencies they're putting into Europe right now?
Yeah, that's pretty crazy. You know, what's happening all over. I mean, the fact that they're actually bringing in these terrorists, allowing them to come in, and then expecting people to assimilate to the jihadi ways, assimilate to Sharia law, and not expect them to assimilate to their cultures that they're coming into.
But you know, isn't it liberal to have your daughter's genitals cut off and to put people in cages and then not let your wife even leave the house and then pour acid on her face if you want to and it's legal?
It's super progressive and trendy. I mean, it's amazing. I think we should do that to everyone. You know, I'm ready to get on the acid train and jump in there. And
well, why doesn't Hillary? I mean, you know, if Islam's so enriching, I don't know why she didn't have Chelsea do that.
You know what is interesting, though, around here, Alex, is the fact that the mainstream media keeps portraying that, you know, there's all these Hillary supporters, that everyone's united. You know, there's hardly any unity inside these halls at the DNC at the Wells Fargo Arena. Hardly any.
Sure, the vast majority are Bernie supporters, and now they're being kicked out, I'm told.
Yeah, it's like remnants of ghosts. There's like ghosts everywhere, like spirits floating around that used to be this revolution that it's just now empty and gone. And now they're all outside protesting at nighttime. But the mainstream media says, oh, there's like 100 or 200 people outside. When in actuality, there are thousands and thousands of angry people. Now imagine all those people all across the country. If they would have shown up to Philadelphia, it would have been a madhouse out here. There's not just a few thousand people who are angry in this country. There are millions and millions.
And by the way, they know it's not Donald Trump that's screwing them over. They know it's the DNC stealing it from them. What's coming up next, Joe? What's coming up next night?
Well, tonight at 6 o'clock, again, the Revolutionary Communist Party are at it again. They're supposed to be doing another flag-burning ceremony, which I will be sure as hell attending and trying to put a stop to that just because, yeah, that's ridiculous. You know, it's funny. I'm glad we're talking about this because last night they were doing flag burnings right outside of the arena.
And another idiot caught themselves on fire.
Well, here's the interesting thing. They started burning flags. They burnt an American flag. They burned just a red flag. They burned another stupid flag. They burned an Israeli flag. And then they brought the rainbow flag over. And I said, burn that flag. And they go, well, no, that's not a flag. That's a symbol. I went, huh? I said, what do you mean? That the rainbow flag is a symbol?
They all engage in doublethink. Well, Joe, I want to be clear. I don't tell you to go grab these flags away. In fact, I mean, quite personally, I think it's their First Amendment, even though they're scum and even though they want to overthrow the country. I know the flag's been a symbol of evil for some people, but overall it's a symbol of good, and we should take it back. But I understand, as you, a veteran, and the rest of it, it's a symbol saying they want to burn you. And so, and I know you've been actually burned up in vehicles yourself, and so it's not a fun thing. At the same time, I just think you should show the rhetoric of how they're anti-gun, anti-family, and I think you should just let people hear these filth. I really think you should let people see the type of person that wants to see this country basically burn up into a communist hell.
Oh, you should have seen the video last night. I put up the death cult revealed or whatever. These people were holding hands, singing around, talking about death to democracy, death to America. America is over. You know, it was like the complete and total death cult for America. It was out of control.
No, these are bad people. I mean, it's like I let my son watch old TV a couple nights a week. We're watching Hawaii 5-0. And I was a kid watching Hawaii 5-0, where the communists are real nasty, and we're going to shoot some people in the back, and then we're going to bring everything down and burn everything because we're evil. And I'm like, you know, when I was a kid, I'm like, that's an exaggeration. There aren't people like that. Then you get around communists, and man, they know they're evil. They don't want to help people. They want to run everything and be able to have us tied up and stomp our guts out because they're little pot-bellied cowards, Joe.
Yeah, exactly. There was one white girl started speaking in front of colored people, and she started speaking and wouldn't shut up because she wanted to say something. And this person of color decided he was going to grovel to her feet and beg the white lady if he could speak before her, and kind of, you know, laughing at her and mocking her. And the video is up as well. I put that up last night. But the insanity out here is not running short. The tank is full, and it's not running empty anytime soon.
Well, I'll tell you, this is what having it too easy does. These people are all on assistance. I don't care what color they are. They're a bunch of bums. They're into weird, sick stuff, and they've never had to actually do anything in their life, and they are mentally ill. They are degenerates, and they want to bring us down. They don't like the fact that we want to build things. They don't like the fact that we're into beauty. They don't like the fact we're into success. They don't like real liberals, and they're coming for us. Joe Biggs, we'll talk to you more. Fabulous job. Thank you, Joe.
Thank you, sir.
All right, I'm going to take a few of your phone calls after we finish up with Knight. Knight, what else is on your agenda? What else are you noticing? I hope you go out. I know you've already done this. Talk to folks about what they believe in, their socialism, their communism, wanting our guns. I think that's really key to document now. You've also documented how they've stolen it from the delegates, so great job. I mean, I've got to tell you, InfoWars, Drudge, others, we are the new media. We're not the alternative media. We are dominating coverage. I'm not bragging. I mean, we're getting more traffic, I know for a fact, than the major CNN shows. It's incredible. I mean, normally 4, 5, 6 million YouTube views a day. We're getting way more than that just on YouTube. You count terrestrial radio. You count all our other platforms. We are reaching just a sickening amount of people. This is very, very exciting.
Well, you know, Alex, you're talking about burning flags and everything. I guess that's why they have so few of them on the stage. But they really are doubling down with it, as we saw them rehearsing in there with Katy Perry, as much red, white, and blue symbolism as they can come up with. But I find it kind of interesting that the socialists, the communists here, are now going full-on McCarthy with these leaks. You know, they've been embarrassed by these leaks, and now they continue to say it's Russia. It's Russia red-baiting like it's the 1950s. It's absolutely amazing. Remember, it was the House Un-American Activities Committee, the HUAC? Well, they just need to change the H from House to Hillary, and we're right back to the old McCarthyism that we had before. But we're going to be talking to people. We've been looking. We saw a couple of people at one point in time. We're on our way to another event that we're here with Everytown. So we want to get some people engaged on this gun control issue, because I'm sure that's going to be a key part of Hillary Clinton's speech tonight. And I want to get some of these people to explain to us why we shouldn't be allowed to protect ourselves when we're in the midst of all of this heavy, heavy security. You know, you have to have a card to come in and get into this area.
Sure, I would ask her then. I would ask these people, why does Hillary have security? Or why does a movie star have security? Well, if you're not rich, you can't afford the security.
And why do you have to have ID cards in order to vote for your Democrat candidate? Isn't that racist? We're told that that's racist when they want to do that in North Carolina. They want to get people's picture ID, but you have to have all kinds of ID.
Ooh, that's a great point. They're even kicking the real voters out, the real delegates, and putting fake ones in. So they're talk about Jim Crow. Great job. Thank you so much, David Knight.
Thank you, Alex.
All right. Amazing to have our reporters there. And I keep saying amazing, amazing. I don't normally use it that much, but they're really doing a great job. And you're doing a great job, listeners. You helped build this operation. We're going to come back, take a few calls. I'm going to go to Kent, and I'm going to go to Raymond and Gwen and Chris and Bill. I'll get to everybody. I appreciate you holding. We are also going to be covering a lot of other news. Tucker Carlson is going to be joining us. First off, though, we're running a special, a sale that is hands down the biggest we've ever had. 40% off on things like Brain Force, 40% off on many other products like the Storable Food. Again, we see the Storable Food maybe once a year, 30% off. It's already super high quality, lowest price you're going to find out there. But my Patriots, the biggest in the country now, and because they're such good quality, and they're all about, we pack it that week, we ship it to you. Everywhere else, it just tends to have back order. They have gotten a little bit back ordered, but I'm told that's when they talked to them last week. They're now not back ordered. They have it in supply, so that means your order will come directly to you. But they told me I need to only run the special for a couple days because it will get back ordered. So, and they don't want to do that to their other suppliers either. So InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWars Select is powered by My Patriot. 20 to 40% off depending on the package. It's 40% off on Brain Force, 20% off on the water filtration systems. So many other specials, 30% on Super Male and Super Female. Everything across the board, huge discounts. And then your purchase of the products, things that help you have, a cleaner body, better health. I mean, just across the board, then funds this operation that no one can doubt is devastating the New World Order. And I do it with good cheer. I'm happy to do it. It's very, very exciting because risking your life is very, very exciting for a good cause. But we're going to go all the way in, through, and beyond. It's that quote from the Black Hole. In, through, and beyond. We're going. We're not stopping. Ever. We're committed, and we're going with God as our standard. Life. Stay with us. No one even cares. They're breaking our will. That it turns out, for months, you search presidential candidate U.S., you don't get Donald Trump, on Google's display. It only shows Hillary and the Green Party and the Libertarian Party. This is beyond 1984. And now TBS has deleted hilarious tweet comparing Hillary to hyenas. Well, we put it back up on Twitter, and Adan Salazar just posted, and it's going on YouTube. And here's the deal. I told YouTube this at the RNC when they were on the YouTube stage, the Young Turks that work for them. They called us up, acted like I took over, blew up, said Roger Stone was on the stage. It was all made up. We're going to Dinesh D'Souza here in 1 minute. But it's thematic of this censorship and persecution. They pulled our three videos of it within an hour. Didn't say copyright violation. Didn't say we took it off. Just said, sorry, unavailable. And I had to go on the internet and threaten to sue Google, which I don't want to do, but I'm going to because it's fundamental free speech. If they take down the hyenas when I put it up, we're going to play it right now. But Dinesh D'Souza was put in prison for 9 months for doing nothing. Went out and got five friends to give money to a political campaign. Didn't fill out a PAC form. But Hillary gets money from dictators. And his crime was having the number two documentary in world history. Now he's already got the highest grossing film documentary of 2016. And it's only been out a week. And I want to thank our listeners. I don't have any financial interest in this. I have an interest in my kids living in somewhat of a free country. But it's all about censorship, and we have to counter it with culture and with art and with supporting information. Now, let's go ahead and play this clip. And now there's this photo of her last night with Obama, like a great white shark cresting. Her actions are so evil, but I just don't know what to say anymore. I'm going to go to your calls if Dinesh goes. I appreciate people holding. We've got Tucker Carlson joining us, too. Dinesh, it was great meeting you in person. I feel like I know you, watching you since I was a kid on TV in the Reagan administration, and then obviously following your films. Congratulations, not just on your best film to date and the new book out by the same name, but congratulations on the fact that you doubled down when they threatened you and tried to destroy your life. So you're a true trailblazer and a veteran of this authoritarian system they're setting up. So it's got to feel good that despite everything they've done to you, that you're back on top.
Alex, thank you very much. No, I'm absolutely thrilled. The left unleashed a whole battery of critics who tried to bash the film into submission through rotten tomatoes and through basically misrepresenting what the film is about. The great thing is we've had people see it. They love it. They go nuts. They tell other people. You've been telling people about it. And so word of mouth is spreading. The fate of a movie depends a lot on how it does in the opening couple of weeks. And so it's just fantastic to see people flood the theaters. We're looking to have a really big weekend this second weekend. We're crushing Michael Moore. He made a film last year. And in 5 days, we have outperformed his film. And our film is already in the top 10 political documentaries of all time in 1 week.
Wow, of all time. Well, incredible. And it's a top
grossing.
We're
in the top 10. My Obama film is number 2, and my film America is number 6.
This film, but Rotten Tomatoes says your film is 5%. Of course, there's a whole genre of films that are so bad, everyone wants to go see them. So in a way, I think you may have the lowest rating ever on Rotten Tomatoes. At least they didn't just delist you. Like Google did.
Well, go to the right of the screen and you'll see that our audience reaction is over 80%. And so you've got probably the biggest spread between what the critics say. By the way, a lot of these critics haven't even seen the movie. They can't find one thing that's wrong with it. So what they do is they go into this kind of thrashing around invective. The film is agitprop, it's paranoid, it's delusional, etc. But the bottom line of it is they can't keep people away from seeing it.
And by the way, sir, for radio listeners, let me describe to them the Rotten Tomatoes page. This is incredible. I miss the forest for the trees. The horrible little globalist minions at Rotten Tomatoes that have disgraced themselves and discredited themselves, attacking any libertine or conservative or patriotic or nationalistic film. I mean, they're well known for this. That's why a lot of folks don't go there now. Gave it a 5%, but the audience rating was 82, incredibly high. So you see the total paradox there of the fraud versus the truth.
Yeah, there's a group called CinemaScore, and this is an objective independent agency. And they interview people as they come out of the theater, and then they rate films. And it's very hard to get an A or an A minus. In fact, the only film playing in the theater right now, other than ours, that got an A minus rating is Star Trek. So from the audience reaction, these are the two best films that are out in the theater. And this includes the whole menu of Hollywood films that are out there this summer.
Well, I mean, your America 2016 was powerful, slick, historic, very good. I felt good watching it. It wasn't gloomy. It was almost upbeat. But you know what? Donald Trump's right. We're in deep crap. Your new film is a horror film. It's very dark, and it comes, I think, close to showing how evil she is. But it's really hard, you know, unless you actually see the kids buried and found dead at MENA with maggots all over them. So, I mean, she is a monster, and so congratulations.
Well, it's just thrilling to have this film in the theater as a kind of vaccination or antidote to the unbelievable squid-like cloud of rhetoric that's coming out of Philadelphia. First of all, to listen to that old con artist Bill Clinton. You know, gee, if we came from Mars and had never heard him before, he might be a reasonably effective used car salesman. But to literally hear this one, given what we know, the selective Rapunzel story of Hillary, I mean, it's downright nauseating. And so I think for Republicans, our film is a great sort of protest vote. It's a way to equip yourself and arm yourself. And in a sense, it's a way of taking a shower from all the false
rhetoric. And we've got to deprogram my family personally. I've been so busy. I still haven't seen it, even though you had us at the premiere. I'm going to see it Saturday. But my family and friends have all been taking liberals and deprogramming them. And they're saying that the liberals already hate her and know she stole the election. So it's they're like being deprogrammed out of a cult right now and totally freaking out. Some people I've talked to say that liberals start crying when they leave.
This is a film that could actually have a transforming effect, not just on independent voters, but also on women, Latinos, and minorities. Now, here's something that's odd. If I were Michael Moore, the whole Democratic Party would have gotten behind me. and they'd be pushing this film for all it's worth. Weirdly, we haven't heard a whisper from the RNC. We haven't heard a whisper from the super PACs. Those are the guys who can actually take this film and drop it in the mailboxes of independent voters. They can do something with it, and they have reach and resources that we don't have. So that might change, but as of now, it's all quiet on the Republican front.
You're right. Speak more to that. I mean, because you're obviously have an astute eye working in the Reagan administration and others and know the behind-the-scenes things. I've been watching on C-SPAN, just how they'll have a camera for an hour when nothing's going on, showing the political operatives. They look really upset, hateful towards each other. The stagehands look really in disarray. The RNC had a great feeling to it, and I've been to others that didn't, but they weren't still anything near the just watching it from afar. My crew's there, and they say they pick it up on the street that it is just like a civil war going on within it and just a feeling of dirtiness.
Absolutely. Well, I mean, just look at this recent email scandal. I mean, the Democrats have been trying to rig their own election, and they're supposed to be a party that carries the name Democratic. The other thing is, it's funny to listen to the way the Democrats talk in private. We show in the movie and in the book that the Democratic Party is the party of bigotry. This is the party that has, far from being the party of minorities, they have been the enslaver, the segregator, the tormentor, the lyncher, the hanger of minority groups and immigrants. And so it's wonderful to see the lifting of the curtain, because now you can see the way they actually think, the way they talk in private. So they put on a big show in Philadelphia, but in private they talk about Hispanics. That's the Taco Bell initiative. They make fun of gays. They want to ridicule Bernie Sanders for his religion. These are very despicable people, but they camouflage and put on this big halo of social justice.
And by the way, I mean, your film exposes all this. Your film exposes all this, obviously, because I've read the reviews. But this is what I experienced growing up. My dad was a Reagan guy. My mom was more of a Democrat, but she liked Reagan. You know, she was like an old-fashioned Democrat. But, I mean, I grew up where we didn't have a bunch of guilt, but we knew people done bad things in this country, and we wanted to build everybody up. And so, you know, it was really bad to be racist, because that's what scum did, because they wanted to feel better about somebody. And being around Republicans in my life, they actually are, like, guilty and really wanting to lift people up on average. I never heard anything racist out of Republicans, not, you know, inside the halls of Congress when I visited, or at events or anywhere, or Pat Buchanan events, whatever. But, man, let me tell you, I've been around Democrats my whole life living in the South, and, man, they are, and even the black Democrats are like managers of the blacks and will say horrible things about black people, like you're in the club with them and like they're the Uncle Tom and you're like totally freaked out. I'll say, I don't want to abort all the black people. And nobody wants them scum and trash. I mean, it's just like the Democratic Party, I guess, always ran the plantations and everything, and they never really stopped. They just got more sophisticated. Sorry, Dinesh.
Yeah, no, they're running urban plantations right now that are very similar in many ways to the old rural plantations. I sneaked my way into the Democratic convention, and I sat down in a corner right near the floor, and I watched all these people walking around, and I just tried to get their vibe. And the vibe I got out of them is that these are the overlords of the new liberal plantation. They walk around like they are overseers, managers, plantation owners.
Very arrogant.
They talk about the people who are dependent on them as if, in a sense, all they care about these people is their votes. Just like in the old days, all that the plantation owners want is to steal the labor of the slaves. All the Democrats today, the new plantation, all they care about, as long as we get these people to vote for us, that's it. That's all we care about.
And then they can point out a few Republican things. There's, you know, obviously Republicans aren't perfect in history. Then a lot of corruption, and then create this cosmology of race like they've done with the police, when statistically it's non-existent.
Yeah, the police are charged with the impossible job of keeping the lid on the liberal plantation. Now think about what it's like to live in those places where there's basically everyone has a meager provision. They give you food and health care, just like on the old slave plantation.
The men aren't allowed in the house.
No opportunity, no hope, nihilism, despair. So the liberal plantation is kind of boiling over, and some of our urban, these shootings and stuff come out of that.
Exactly. So the left knows they've double black employment, all this to make them more dependent, and then they're just blaming the enforcers that they have there trying to keep the lid on it. That's why I have some issues with the police, obviously, and I want to reform some of the problems, but it's a total scapegoat to just randomly attack people in blue and just say they're the problems in America.
And whatever the problems we have, I mean, the very idea that Bill and Hillary, this kind of Bonnie and Clyde operation that's in it for themselves, that doesn't care about domestic policy, nor do they care about foreign policy. They're just like brokers who want to collect 10%, and that's all they care about. And so the idea that they can fix problems is just ludicrous. Now, you know, we've had crooks in American politics before, but we didn't know they were crooks in advance. With Hillary, the Democrats know, and they've still put her forward. And I think that actually is a referendum on the character of this party that would advance a known crook as their standard bearer.
That is exactly what I've been saying, independent of you, because it's prima facie. It's just truth. So what does that say? I mean, either they end up winning the world. I don't think they're going to back off now. If they get in, they're going to go for everything. They're not going to stop. Clearly, we've got to defeat them now. Or even if she gets in, we have to stop her because this nation's never faced more peril with naked election stealing, naked primary stealing, naked stealing from the Sanders voters. This is unprecedented.
Yeah, I think ultimately we don't want, you know, a gangster running America. This is sort of like Al Capone in the White House. Now, when Al Capone was virtually running Chicago, he wanted full access to the Treasury. He wanted to be able to give contracts to his buddies. He wanted to be able to snuff out his opponents or throw them off the stage. He wanted to be able to walk into the Cubs stadium and have the whole crowd shout with cult-like dedication, Big Al, Big Al, Big Al. And that's what Hillary wants. That's Hillary's goal for herself. And this is not, I think, what we want in America. I grew up in India. It's a country run by gangs, slumdog millionaire style. I came to America for something different. It'll be so disheartening for me as an immigrant to see that third world kind of gangsterism come here to America.
Well, I know this. You can't go to Italy or India or China or Russia and be an outsider and end up being heading a federal department and a speechwriter and a guy that, you know, speaks to tens of millions of people and is so respected. I mean, I know you love America. I mean, America's not perfect, but boy, isn't it the best place out there to be able to really advance somebody who's got the talent like you, who deserves to be successful, who can enrich society like you've done, Dinesh?
You know, the choice in America is between two things. There are ladders of opportunity, and that's the Republican Party. And the ladder is good because you can climb up the ladder, and how far you get depends on luck and it depends on your own efforts. The Democratic alternative is that they don't believe in ladders. They believe that they're sitting on top of the roof and they're putting a rope down and they're asking you to hang on to the rope and they will pull you up. And what people don't realize, they think, oh, well, the ladder, you know, the ladders work. The rope is easy. I'll take the rope. But you don't realize they don't intend you to pull you up all the way. They want to pull you up somewhat and then hold, because that way they have you where they want you. They have you in a position of enforced dependence. You can't go anywhere.
Are they not creating a new caste system, a class system?
They have a caste system with themselves at the top, and they're the only ones that come out ahead. Look at the people who live on the liberal plantation. They never get ahead.
The film, the book, the book's obviously important. People can get that at Amazon.com or at HillarysAmericaTheMovie.com. You can find out, put your zip code in where it's showing. But now it's showing pretty much everywhere. I think it's in like 10 theaters in Austin. Again, a lot of my family went last weekend. They were amazed by it. My mother, again, didn't like Hillary and the Democrats, but she, you know, she sure didn't like, you know, the Bushes either. But I tell you, she is just sick. Like, she can't even look at Hillary now.
The beauty of a movie, it's $10. You know, this is a way to use your influence to put fuel in our rocket. If you've seen the movie, you love it, go see it again. Take students, buy them tickets, get them to the movie theater. That
it's
helps
a referendum against them trying to censor everybody and throw us in jail.
It's a power. Movies are a powerful weapon. You can watch a film in 90 minutes and come out of it at the end of it a little different on the inside. I think if we could show this film to independents and blacks and minorities, it would discombobulate them. It would traumatize
them. I agree. Final segment, Dinesh, and then calls, folks, and then our next guest, Tucker Carlson. We're back in 3 minutes with Dinesh D'Souza. Folks, you have to admit you've been conned, though. Okay? It's like a Nigerian email scam. You've got to admit you've been conned. Dinesh D'Souza with us for six more minutes, then your phone calls, I promise. Appreciate folks holding. I don't have a stake in Dinesh D'Souza's film. But other filmmakers come to me and offer me money to even promote their films. And if I see the film and think it's good, I just say, hey, I'm going to promote it. I don't need any money. Of course, D'Souza hasn't offered that. The point is that this is a platform to get stuff out they don't want you to see. I'm willing to give my life to defeat the tyrants. So obviously, I want to promote something that is so powerful and is so informative that it's transformative. By extension, You need to get the Hillary for President shirts at InfoWarsStore.com. You need to buy the nutraceuticals. You need to get the water filters, the products, all this. If you're not filtering your children's water with a real filter that cuts out the garbage, not just bad taste, shame on you. And I'm not trying to shame you so you buy my product. It's just you're crazy with the garbage that's in our water, the runoff, all of it. So when you buy our products, that's what makes all this possible. Thousands of great products, many times the lowest prices you're going to find, but regardless, it helps fund our operation. You can also make a donation today. I haven't really pushed that, but if you want to make a straight donation, InfoWarsStore.com. That'll help us be able to budget that we can get a few more reporters, camera people, and folks into the new year. I kind of use this fundraiser once a year, you know, mega sale fundraiser, to be able to budget, hey, I can get a few new people or fill in some holes or some gaps or get new equipment or build a new studio or how much money we've got for trips. We need to raise a lot of money. I can tell you right now that the average talk show host on almost 200 stations like I am with top ratings in many cities now on 50,000-watt stations, we've broken through. I'd have a private jet and some 20-room mansion. I can't keep my four-bedroom house clean. So I don't want a private jet and a mansion. I built this with the money. Other talk show hosts could have done this. They build mansions. And so that's why we need the funds to really even do more. Because the money, I'm a free market guy all the way. I want money to be secure, take care of my family, have good medical care, have a car that runs well, have decent clothes. But I don't worship it. Global's put a gun to my head and say, you know, join us, we're going to kill you. I say, pull the trigger, punk, because all I've got is my integrity. And I know Dinesh D'Souza has his integrity as well. So buy our products, InfoWarsStore.com. We got 3 minutes left, Dinesh. Thanks for coming on. It's great to have you more often than just once or twice a year. I hope you'll join us a lot. In 3 minutes, what other great, because it is great knowledge and experience, can you impart to the audience about the critical crossroads we've now reached?
Yeah, I think one of the...
And Dinesh's internet is breaking up. That's why I wasn't going to him earlier. I saw it was breaking up. I was trying to give it time to reconnect.
Once you force them to admit all their crimes, all the horrible stuff the Democratic Party has done, from Indian removal, segregation, slavery, all the way down the line, they go, okay, yes, we admit it, but we changed. The Democrats saw the light, and all the racists became Republicans. And so this is an effort to put the blame on Republicans and also on the South and on America. America did these things. Now, there was, in fact, no big switch. The whole case hinges on one guy, Strom Thurmond, a Dixiecrat Democrat who became a Republican. But if you make a list of the hundreds of racist Democrats, they never switched. Think of a guy like Robert Byrd, who was in the Ku Klux Klan, remained a hero in the Democratic Party. All the grand dragons of the Ku Klux Klan going down through decades and even centuries, they all remained Democrats. So this notion of a big switch is a fraud that is perpetrated by the progressives to shift blame from themselves.
That's right. And the film, Hillary's America, themovie.com, Hillary's America. It's our duty to see this film. It is number one now in the top 10 ever. Let's make it number one. Congratulations, Dinesh D'Souza. Go with God. We're proud of you. It's good to have you fighting for Team Humanity.
Thank you so much.
You'll be back with your phone calls. T-minus 70 seconds. I'm Alex Jones. All right, Carlson's on for 30 minutes, and then I'll take calls. I'm going to your calls right now. Kent, and then Raymond, and Chris, and James, everybody, Robert, I'll get to you. Kent in California, thanks for holding. I get greedy and have the calls, and I have a guest, and don't get to you. But most of us would just hang up on you, so I don't apologize too bad. But thank you for tuning in. Go ahead, Kent. Thanks for calling.
Hey, Alex. Big thank you to be on your show. Appreciate it.
I wanted
to have two quick points. One, the first, actually three, but I promise the first two are quick. One, I want to say to anybody listening that the fact that you, and I'll politicize this for a second, but the fact that you and most right-wing, I would assume that we're going to go with here, shows take live callers means that you're ready to defend your opinions and defend what you believe in, regardless of what's going to happen. Left shows do not do this. They will never take a live call because they do not want to have their entire narrative messed up by
They're
somebody.
They're obsessed with control. I mean, if you want to free humanity, you want the animating contest. But if you don't, you want to have your own little paradigm you run.
That you're allowing calls to go on your YouTube show that anyone can view, and you're allowing anyone to come up here and say anything to you, even if I don't agree with you, that is an amazing fact just in itself. But I wanted to alert our viewers. One of the things, whenever I mention you a lot, is not everyone agrees on some things that you say I don't agree with, which is fine. That's what America's about.
Now, let's say it. Some of the time I'm unlistenable. Believe me, I'm my worst critic.
One of the things that the left does to discourage, and I know we don't like him as much anymore, but George Schaefer talked about this, was once you control the vocabulary, you control the argument. And whatever you bring up, any type of corruption or misdeed, what they yell at is conspiracy theory. And there are such things as those, but when you...
Now, they don't want the little people discussing the turkey coup, so they call discussing it a conspiracy theory.
Absolutely. You had Tim Kennedy go on, I believe it was 2 weeks before, and he said, look, I can't tell you when, but America is here, it's prime for attack, there's a lot of rage, just beware. And then literally within, a three-week span, three attacks happen, all within Tim Kennedy's description. And then you're like, well, that's not a conspiracy theory. If someone puts evidence forward, puts opinions forward and says, this is going to happen, and then it happened, how could you label that as a conspiracy theory? A conspiracy theory is when I just make up a bunch of dots and connect them and have no logical way to get there.
Yeah, they're telling you you're not allowed to have critical thinking.
Yeah. So I wanted to tell our wearers, be aware that when it comes to controlling the argument, the left does a great job at controlling the vocabulary. So do not let them put you down by just saying it's a conspiracy theory, especially when you yourself put up articles, you put up links, you're saying, look, I'm not making this up.
Sure, but I mean, we're dealing with a bunch of dumb people that follow this, that want to believe something simple and stupid. I appreciate your call, Kent. Raymond in Kentucky, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Hey, yeah. Here's the thing, okay? It terrifies the establishment that Trump is an independent candidate. I mean, he owes a few people peanuts and stuff like that. But other than that, he's supporting his own campaign, which means he's not going to owe anybody anything when he gets in. That is terrifying to a corrupt system. And
by the way, he's taking zero money from Big Pharma. That right there, the guy's a superstar of goodness.
Right, exactly. You see my point. And the next point I'd like to make is our forefathers didn't stand for the government that had control over them, occupying their own country. Why would we allow the U.S. government, a corrupt government, who is trying to exert control on the people to maintain absolute control, why would we allow them to occupy us?
One word.
You know, and
one word, television. They've created an artificial fantasy land that most people sit in front of all day that's artificial disinformation and totally controlled, so people are living in fantasy land.
They need to wake up. I would use the F word, but I know that's not permitted. Yeah, they need to wake up.
No, you're right, Raymond. We don't just mean wake up figuratively. Medically, many people are in a near sleepwalking trance state. The TV puts them into that brainwave, you know, the mainline TV. I appreciate your call. Great points, Raymond. All right, we'll get to Chris next, and then we'll get to Robert and James and Wes and many others, 800-259-9231. And then, coming up, Tucker Carlson from the DNC. Stay with us.
Do you like Hillary?
Yep, been supporting her for over 10 years, of course.
And what do you think about the FBI director coming out and saying she had 110 classified emails?
I did not send or receive any information.
DNC coverage. I'm Alex Jones.
From the group of 30,000 emails returned to the State Department in 2014, 110 emails in 52 email chains have been determined by the owning agency to contain classified information at the time they were sent or received.
At the time.
At the time they were sent or received.
No.
You don't believe it?
No. Hey, we're good.
All right, we're good.
Tony, in order to support Hillary, you have to deceive yourself and
pretend that crime doesn't matter.
Yeah, exactly. Pretend the crime doesn't matter.
Hey, you voting for Hillary Clinton?
So what are your big issues? Are you for gun control?
Yes.
Eliminate them. Yeah. Take them out of the hands of the people.
Trust Hillary. Hillary's the best. Go Hillary.
Disturbing.
Disturbing.
Who are you voting for?
Who am I voting for?
Yeah.
Clinton.
I ain't giving you no change. I give you.
Come on, buddy. Please.
Vote for Hillary. Trump is not going to get the vote.
Disturbing.
Disturbing.
All right, we got the Peace Bernie bike coming down here.
Yeah, Bernie is like the best candidate I've seen.
People are trying to climb over the fence now to get into where the DNC is taking place.
Of course, they tried to shut him down because it's rigged.
As far as I'm concerned, there she's clear. Hillary Clinton is cleared from all charges.
And I am for gun control.
You don't have our vote, you don't have our money, and Trump's gonna flatten you like a pancake, Hillary.
Obama's totally awesome, we're gonna miss him.
F you, Hillary Clinton.
We're not voting for Hillary in no way, shape, form, or fashion. That's a wrap. No, like, everything that she's done, everything that she's about, we cannot just fall in line. No matter if Bernie's supporting her, I don't care who's supporting her. I'm not supporting her, and that's just that. She doesn't hold none of our values. She holds no one's value. She's not accountable. She's not held accountable for anything. She wasn't held accountable for the emails. She wasn't held accountable for Benghazi. She wasn't held accountable for Libya. She's not held accountable for anything. So nobody in their right mind should even think about voting for that lady.
What do you think about the FBI director saying, basically saying every reason why she was guilty, but then saying she should be let off?
He was paid. Or he knows that a hit team will come after him. That's what I believe.
You think Bernie Sanders was paid off?
No, I don't think Bernie was paid off.
Director Comey.
We're talking about Director James Comey.
Yes.
He knows something that we don't know. You know what I mean?
Suspicious. It feels pretty funny.
Something happened.
His life was threatened, I bet.
And I think Bernie's life was
coming up in 60 seconds.
For him to do that, for him to say we're going to a contested convention and then give in, for him to think that... I just can't fathom it. Like, I really can't fathom it anymore. Like, it's just crazy.
Why do you think that the election was stolen? I mean, do you think that Hillary is there to...
11 states that have reported election fraud. 11 states. That goes beyond the margin of error.
Well, why is Hillary doing this? Why is Hillary doing this? What's her game plan?
Me, personally, I think she want to go to war with Russia. That's what I think.
That's a few minutes of the bedlam going on a daily basis outside the DNC, where their own constituents are rebelling against them. Sanders clearly won California and New Hampshire and other states. They're just not letting the delegates actually be there. They're putting in fake delegates, super delegates. This is so naked that it's not even a, quote, conspiracy theory. It's so crazy to see Clinton toddling around like a corpse, Hillary running around looking like the Joker, that I'm wondering if this is like some simulation. Is it really happening? Of course, I'm being sarcastic. Tucker Carlson's been nice enough during his lunch hour covering the DNC for Fox to join us. He's the founder of the 24-hour news site, thedailycaller.com. And, of course, everybody knows who he is, so no need to get into the libertarian conservative's background, dailycaller.com, 20-plus-year veteran of journalism. Tucker, the world is really getting crazy. I could ask a lot of questions here, but I want to ask you, where do we start? I mean, is this not a referendum on the decaying establishment? I think Trump has proven that the old Republican establishment's going out. It looks like the Democrats are trying to hang on. Will they be successful?
Well, you want me to say, you have really captured the fun vibe here in Philadelphia. I mean, it is the most unhappy city I've been to in a long time. I keep running.
Cleveland was like a party. It was fun.
It's unbelievable. Actually, the Bernie people were very nice.
Yeah.
At least to me, and I'm not sympathetic to their economic program, but the thing that distinguishes the Bernie people from the Hillary people here is that they actually believe in something. So if you stand at the entrance to the convention center and you watch people file in, the Bernie people, you know, I mean, they're always friendly, always nice. The Hillary people are mostly lobbyists from Washington or sort of 70s era feminists. And it's a completely different feeling. So the Bernie people really are true believers, and I'm not using that as an insult, but rather as a compliment. I mean, they believe in something, and they're
shocked.
Oh,
they have a million times more credibility than just the Washington insiders.
I think they do. They have if you've met them, you show up, and they want to tell you what they believe, and they want to convince you that they're right. The Hillary people have no interest in convincing you. They're interested in power, acquiring it, wielding it, mostly for their own benefit. I mean, it's not just Hillary. Of course, it's the establishment. It's people who've benefited from the last 15 years in America who become richer and more powerful. They obviously don't want change, and a lot of other people do.
Let me ask you this question, and I want to get into what front and center for you, Tucker. All the scandals, though, it just has a smell, a feeling. Like, I know if she gets in, she's going to get impeached. I know there's nothing she can do short of becoming a dictator or something. And she looks so ill. I mean, she just looks like a failure. Clinton looks like he's about to die. He's up there shaking. I mean, it just seems like a joke. So I feel like we're winning even if Trump doesn't get in.
Well, I will say this. I haven't met a single person who likes Hillary. I mean, a lot of my neighbors.
I haven't either.
No, I mean, it's so strange. A lot of people I live near are voting for her. They're here supporting her. But they're doing so because they see material gain in her election. They want to be ambassador to Belgium. And so they're here, you know, signing on early to the program. But I haven't met anybody, not one person who says, you know, I really like her. I think she's a good person. She's an honest person. She's direct. She'll be a great leader. I haven't heard that at all. She's the default candidate. I think they are suffering from sort of the opposite of what the Republicans are suffering from. They had no field. There were no real candidates. It was basically Bernie Sanders, that loser governor from Maryland, and Hillary Clinton.
So because they're so controlled, like the Communist Politburo. So let me ask you this then. Where do you see this going?
Well, I mean, Hillary Clinton's the nominee. I'm leaving in a minute to go watch her give her speech tonight here. And she's really the candidate for people who are terrified by or disgusted by Donald Trump. And mostly that means on the left, people who think he's racist. So the rest of this campaign is going to be about one thing. Donald Trump is a bigot, because that is the fastest way to get Democratic voters to the polls to vote against bigotry. I'm convinced that's their only campaign tactic. They're not even, here's the thing, and I'm not hardly endorsing Trump, but I'm just struck by this. They're not even engaging his argument. You haven't seen one person in Philadelphia explain why mass immigration is good for America. Not one person has explained that, or why our current trade deals have been a great success for the middle of the country. Nobody is even pretending that those are arguments.
Instead, Obama says Hillary will enforce immigration law when he's ignoring it. It's just crazy.
Right. It's not an adult exchange of ideas. And you see it in the press, too. You know, Donald Trump is a lunatic. Donald Trump has no self-control. By the way, Donald Trump doesn't have much self-control. But is that really the point? The point is Trump makes a specific case about a bunch of different policies. If you disagree with that case, tell me why. Tell me why he's wrong and give me.
I disagree with the 0% interest rates, but he's not out to get America, so I'm supporting him.
Right. Exactly.
Tucker, for you, what are the central themes now? What are you looking for as the next shoe to drop?
Well, in the Hillary campaign, I mean, it's, you know, there's a lot out there. The WikiLeaks emails, as far as I know, have not been fully vetted by anybody. There are just too many of them. And so it's possible we'll hear more there. By the way, if the DNC emails were hacked, who knows whose emails have been hacked? You know, which is something, by the way, to think about if you communicate by email all day, as I do. I mean, you wouldn't want your email out there. Probably time to change your password. But I think there's going to be more of that kind of thing that comes out. But for me, the campaign theme, the only one that matters to me is immigration, because it touches on everything.
It's basic sovereignty. I mean, you've got to follow the law. Exactly. You can't just open it up and give people free stuff.
There's no more important question than who gets to live in your country and who gets to vote for its leadership. That's the basic question that any country faces, and immigration affects that directly. So I'd like to see, I hope, and it probably won't happen, but I'd really like to see a national referendum, a national debate on that question. Do we have too many immigrants coming in? Not enough? I mean, let's talk it out.
And I saw one this morning that's starting to get picked up. One of these hacked emails is the Clinton and campaign telling Google what hashtags to block, you know, for crooked Hillary and stuff. And then now Google won't even let you, as of this morning, they may have changed it, search presidential candidate. Donald Trump doesn't even show up. I mean, this is so transparent.
Well, the problem is, as you know, is you have a couple of companies with more power than any media company has ever wielded in the history of the country. There's just never been a monopoly like Facebook or Google ever. And so, you know, the potential for abuse of power is huge. And by the way, both of those companies are deeply tied in to the Democratic establishment, to the Obama administration, to the Hillary campaign. You know, I think we don't exactly know what's going on, but it's really clear to me there's massive potential for abuse, scary abuse, the kind of abuse that controls public opinion. I mean, that should make any normal person nervous.
Well, sure, search engine heads and Zuckerberg have bragged about this, and now they're doing it. And it just makes a joke of the term, don't be evil. Let me ask you this question. They've got national polls out, as you know, LA Times and others, with them 7.3 ahead, 7.8 ahead. Internal polling, I've been told, showing that number. I said that a week ago, 7 or so. Obviously, it's an electoral college, so you got battleground states. But my gut is there's a lot of folks that are closeted who are really going to vote for Trump. In fact, that's what people are telling me. So let's say he's really 10 points ahead. Let's say he narrowly wins. If Hillary's already stolen the nomination, they're already rigging search engines, they're already doing all this, they're already announcing, you know, the day before that the donors decided Hillary would win California. I mean, Tucker, isn't it safe to say that we expect Hillary or her people to try to steal the election if they've already stolen the nomination?
Well, look, whenever you frame an election as not a contest between ideas, like I think this, you think that, let's see who the voters agree with. That's what an election has typically been in our country. They framed it this way. You have a fascist dictator trying to take over America. He's evil and we're virtuous. If you frame it that way, you kind of justify any level of extremism, right? If you really thought Hitler was going to take over the country, what wouldn't you do to stop it? What wouldn't you justify in your own mind to prevent that from happening?
Nothing. But see, Hillary's the one stealing. She's the Hitler.
Look, I'm just saying.
I understand what you're saying. Yeah. It's just that, again, everything's inverted. Let me ask you this. Talking, obviously, you talked to some high-level Democrats and people, who were there at Fox News or, you know, around at the DNC. What is their sense? I mean, you were kind of implying they're just there to be on the bandwagon?
Yes. Yes, but they also hate Trump. I mean, it's so funny. I had this really interesting conversation at a Bernie rally the other day. I think your guys may have been there, actually. But I was talking to this woman, and I said, well, what do you care about? What are the issues you really care about? And she said, I'm really mad about trade. I think our trade agreements hurt Americans. And I think, number two, Wall Street has too much influence in our electoral process. And I said, you want to hear something weird? Trump said that exact same thing the other night. And she basically she refused to believe me. I mean, it's true. Those are Trump's.
That's right. They're so compartmentalized. This is how Google does it, where liberals, conservatives, other people are kept in their little, they feed you what they think you want to hear. They don't even know what Trump really stands for.
Exactly. That's exactly right. And I also think Trump could do a better job sticking on the issues. I mean, that's, I think, would be really helpful. Let me just say this. I think the left hates Trump so much and is so intent on holding on to control of the executive branch that I don't think many on the left will accept a Trump presidency. Now, I'm not sure exactly what that means, but my sense is they will not see him as legitimate, for real, in a way that we've never seen in my lifetime anyway, in 47 years. They're not going to accept him as president, and many of them anyway.
So you're talking about civil unrest, Tucker.
I'm not sure what I'm talking about, but I, you know, for the decades I've lived in Washington, 30 years, there's been this sense, well, I don't want the other guy to win, but if he does, he's the president of the United States. Like, I don't know, you know, I'm an American, he's the president. I'll sort of get in line. I may not like it, but I'm not going to pretend he's not the president. I think things have changed. It's the sense I have. I have no evidence for this, but that many on the left are going to say, you know what, he's not the president.
Well, I think you do have evidence. Look at all the civil unrest that Obama and Hillary have been fomenting. What do you think's behind that?
Well, I think you're exactly right. I think there's been an awful lot of racial demagoguery just in the last few days, last 3 days here in Philadelphia, but I think for the last 8 years. I mean, from day one, Obama has made the case if you disagree with him, you just don't like him because he's black. You're a racist. You're a bad person. You're immoral. When you say that, or you imply it, as he has again and again and again, totally unfairly, there's no evidence that the average American is racist. That's just not, that's not true. But he keeps
the average American's sick of hearing about it. I'll tell you that.
I agree with that. And you divide people on a deep level. Not just, they don't just disagree with each other on the issues. You're for TPP. I'm against it. They hate each other based on tribal affiliation. And those wounds are very slow to heal. It takes generations to heal those wounds. I think this guy has intentionally divided people, presumably to increase his own power. I don't know, but I can tell
no
you.
No doubt.
Terrible effect.
Tucker, you talk about there being some type of permanent emergency, maybe if Trump gets in, and obviously they vowed to do that, so there is evidence to it. But I got to tell you, if Hillary openly steals this election after stealing the nomination, I mean, I'm a peaceful guy, so I'm not going to do anything violent. But at a certain point, how do we up, you know, the political temperature to try to stop this if they're banning words, saying mother and father are bad, the borders are open outside of law, they're about to appoint 5 Supreme Court justices probably, you know, in the next 4 to 8 years. I mean, this is a nightmare scenario. And I almost feel guilty if I don't do something else, but I don't know what I do that they don't end up turning against myself or the Republic. I mean, I'm really having these thoughts now, like, well, we're really turning into a third world crazy town.
Well, they've been radicalized for sure. And I think they are, to give them credit for sincerity, I think they're genuinely afraid of Trump. I do think that. I think they're really threatened by the guy. They don't understand him. They don't know where he's coming from. They can't predict his next move. They don't think they can negotiate with him. And I think they really feel cornered. And, you know, I hope that people don't resort to extremism like stealing elections. But you never know. People who feel deeply threatened do, you know, things they wouldn't do otherwise. And it definitely makes me really uncomfortable. I love this country. I have nowhere else to go. I don't have another passport. I grew up here. I don't want things to go to hell. And you really feel like when political leaders say, and they've said this flat out, if you don't like the law, don't obey it, or the whole system is corrupt and therefore illegitimate, it's racist, that's when things start to go the way.
And then it's all selective, though. Then they throw Dinesh D'Souza for campaign contributions in jail while Hillary's getting money from Gulf states illegally. Exactly. It's like it's so rigged with the system out to get you because you're an evil American, or you're a white guy, or you're a libertarian, you're a conservative, and then you haven't done anything. And then, you know, the groups even attacking you are being screwed over. I mean, it's really scary.
No, that is such a good description. Even the groups attacking you are being screwed over. Right. I mean, if this were 1917, they'd be the Mensheviks. You know, they played a kind of useful role.
Yeah, exactly.
They're cast aside.
Let me look. You're out there in the streets, but you're also, you know, at highest levels of media. Obviously, the military has been concerned. They blocked funding ISIS and what Obama tried to do. General Flynn and others, Rand Paul to his credit, Ted Cruz to his credit. So there does seem to be an understanding now that we have this Machiavellian elite that are not even party affiliated now. They're just crazy. And I think folks are having it click now that things are out of control. I mean, that's what I'm picking up from billionaires and generals and folks. They don't know what to do. Because when you get into the kind of the bureaucratic level and the politico level, that even, because I'm not defending bureaucrats saying the CIA or the FBI or the military, but they at least know starting a war with Russia might cause nuclear war. It just seems like you got a bunch of power mad, crazy communists and weird feminists and communists, and they've got power. They're ruling the country. They walk on red carpets. They have mansions, but they still have some victimology 60s weirdo stuff to, like, get the man. And the man's some poor white guy down in a coal mine, you know, with black lung. I mean, I always thought leftism was just a cover for their takeover, but I really get they, I think, actually drink a lot of their own Kool-Aid. I know I'm ranting. Cocker, can you hear me now?
Yeah, I hear you perfectly, and I think that was so smart. You just got cut off right at the end. When you pointed out that the people in power describe themselves as victims, there are two things going on. One, the left kind of inherently needs to feel morally superior. They need the moral high ground because that's really the whole point. The whole left project is the good people rule the mediocre people, rule the bad people. The people with clean hearts are in charge of the people with, you know, filthy intentions. A. B, when you're a victim, it means by definition never having to say you're sorry or look back and critically assess what you've done. And so you have this incredibly bizarre situation where the president of the United States claims to be a victim. He's a victim. And you have Hillary Clinton saying, one of the, you know, richest and most famous people in the world, that every white person is somehow, literally, she said this, privileged and need to examine their privilege. So the unemployed machinist in Cleveland is somehow more privileged than the Harvard-educated president, really?
Who wakes up in a house built by slaves, poor baby, and then it expands on that. You have Bernie Sanders saying, white people don't know what it's like to be poor.
Well, exactly. When rural America is collapsing in on itself in the saddest possible way, it's a slow motion disaster that we're all ignoring.
Wow. I mean,
it really is. It's the saddest thing I think I've ever seen, what is happening to America outside of the big population centers. It's just absolutely awful. And these people are intent on attacking the people who are suffering.
Well, he said that's the enemy, the bitter clingers. In closing, dailycaller.com, Tucker Carlson, founder of that, of course, a journalist at Fox News. In closing, who's going to win? I mean, who do you think, just stole or not? Who's the next president going to be?
This is the way I think of it. He's got the best message ever. He has trouble articulating it. She has no message at all. Vote for me. I'm a woman. He wins if he stays disciplined. That's my view.
All right, Tucker, thank you so much. We'll be watching your coverage at dailycaller.com. Stay with us, folks. I'm Alex Jones, Infowars.com. This is a very exciting time to be alive. I'm not going to be playing fantasy football here in the next few months. Probably the most important election in U.S. history. Definitive. We know with Hillary, they are going to take us beneath the waves. They are going to bankrupt this country and turn us into a third world nation on purpose to control us. They want to extinguish the American system that never even got off the ground, but just the idea produced so many great ideas, inventions, and wealth that changed the world. I just couldn't imagine being one of these globalists and then wanting to suppress everybody while I ran around telling everyone how much I love them. It is the triumph of fraud, the triumph of a galactic-sized hoax. But they get away with it because the Republican leadership is almost as bad and works with them. And along comes Donald Trump, who's a nationalist and a patriot, and who could turn into a strong man like Vladimir Putin. But I'll tell you this, I know Hillary, and I know she's bad news, and you are insane if you support her, because you support fraud and deception and stolen elections and Gulf states flooding her with money and the communist Chinese. I mean, the worst. You know about the Chinese murdering hundreds of thousands of political dissidents a year, tens of millions over the years. And she's like, oh, it's just the Chinese. Everywhere we go, people scream, you're an effing white male, and they're weird white people. It's like this royalty they have to just run around squawking. You know, Chinese kill 84 million of their own people. It's cute because they're Chinese. It's not bad when communists kill somebody and they're Chinese. But, oh my gosh. There were probably over 1,000 lynchings from 1900 to 1970. Oh my, wow, whoa, geez. I mean, okay, great. It's my fault. I did it. You know, it's just the numbers we're talking about here. But it's how Hollywood just inflames these wounds. They're not well-meaning liberals in Hollywood, folks. They're not well-meaning liberals in the Democratic Party. They are creepy controllers who think everybody's dumb and who are trying to make you as dumb as possible so they can control you. Briefly, we are running the biggest special wide spectrum we have ever run at InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com, takes you to nutraceuticals, as a big fundraiser. We're not calling this a money bomb. If you want to donate, you're certainly welcome to, and we appreciate that. It goes towards more reporters and crew. And again, we don't get mega corporation money. We got 2 hours, 23 minutes left in the transmission. That'll be 28 hours. The free feed is at Infowars.com/show or Infowars.com/giant. And you can go there and find the discounts. Get these unprecedented specials at InfowarsStore.com right now for the Operation Sleeping Giant Supercell fundraiser. 40% off BrainForce, the amazing nootropic. It's a great way to just, if you've never wanted to try these out or do want to try them out, to now have this introductory offer, this low price. 40% off Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver. 20% off all Pro Pure Water Filters. 20% off all Alexa Pure Air Filters. 30% off all Survival Shield X2. 30% off Supermel Vitality. 30% off Vitamin Mineral Fusion. 30% off Secret 12 Vitamin B12. 30% off DNA Force. 20% off all Survival Seeds. 20% off all shirts, 30% off Liber Shield, 30% off Deep Cleanse, 30% off Anthroplex, 30% off Knockout. Just Knockout alone, if you're all amped up and can't go to bed and got to get up early to go take a play in the morning, it's midnight, can't go to sleep, take two of these, and it's just got a large dose, a good dose, of melatonin, L-tryptophan, valerian root, and like eight other things or seven other things. And it'd be like $50-$60 trying to get all these by themselves at the same dose. It's just a really good, organic, serious dose of everything. Deep, healthful, good rest. InfoWarsLife.com. And that's just one of the products there. Try BrainForce. We've never had 40% off on that. And there's other discounts as well. 20% off all the Patriot apparel. Hillary for prison shirts. Bill Clinton rape shirt. It's time to get aggressive with the scum. They don't want us exercising the First Amendment because we're devastating them with it. You got the new Molon Labe Come and Take It Texas style shirts in camo and gray. Really comfortable shirts. Got that kind of fabric that's a mix of some type of artificial stuff. And I don't have a shirt with me. It just feels so good. And cotton. And all of this, so we have the Make America Free Again shirts that are ripoffs of Trump's. And it's not a total ripoff, but it's a, you know, kind of a uptake on it. I think an upgrade on it. But InfoWarsLife.com, InfoWarsStore.com, or call toll-free 888-253-3139. And it's revolutionary when you fund us, when you share a link, an article, a video. They're doing everything they can to censor this. I mean, Google is not letting people have search results for presidential candidate Donald Trump. They're not letting you see stories about Hillary being corrupt. I mean, this is admitted. They meet multiple times a week with the White House. On average, 5 hours. They think they can dominate you. They think you can give Dinesh D'Souza's film a 5% rating, and then the public gives it, what, an 84, 85%. Okay, thank you for holding. We're going to go in order here. Chris in Canada. And then to everybody else, Chris in Canada, you're on the air worldwide. Thank you for joining us on this 28-hour transmission.
Hi, Lux, and thank you for taking my call. I just wanted to give you an idea of what I believe is happening right now. I think we're on the verge of basically witnessing a dictatorship being formed. And some of the pieces that are put in place before the dictatorship can happen have already happened, and none of us have really put the pieces together. So, for example, as a society is controlled by military, religion, music, and entertainment industry, and all those places, like we had our military, or the U.S. had their military purge at the beginning of the year, last year, and religion is controlled, the music, entertainment business industries are controlled, the business and banks are controlled. The last spot where people still had a free choice or had a way of protecting themselves was a court system. Now, the judge was murdered a few months ago or, you know, a little while back. So now all the major spots where a dictatorship could be stopped are online or complicit with this dictatorship. Now comes the option of how to make Obama, maybe Obama himself isn't in this, but other people are, how to make him in this position. I think Mr. Tucker touched on it. Now, when you present the people with an option of either having Hitler as your leader or, you know, that's it, like Hillary will not win, and I think Obama's team or people in Obama's circle are behind the Hillary releases of the emails so as to make Hillary less viable option for the people. So now if Trump is the only option you have, people will accept, you know, Obama running for a second or a third term, or even saying that we should not hold elections and, you know, save democracy, save freedom. And this whole dynamic is being put forward to the people. And I believe a dictatorship's going to emerge in the U.S. along, you know, then you have the banking industry that will make a collapse, stress the people out, have a very anxious and stressed out population that's willing to accept any type of, you know, suggestion. And there you go. And you have this dictatorship. And I think it's everything's falling in place slowly but surely as the election comes up.
Well, I completely agree with your analysis, Chris. And the social engineers are doing things like openly stealing nominations and openly having the central government say, go out and kill cops to just create the total destabilization where the cops are scared, the local public's scared. And so if you just maintain order, we'll put up with whatever. Just like in Europe. I mean, it's so transparent. I said this like 4 years ago. Ship in the Islamists, let them attack, censor people's speech against it, then declare martial law, put troops on the streets. They've done it. They've changed the French and German constitution. They're changing others now. The EU is bringing a dictatorship in because the death of memory, the death of logic. Hollande should be arrested. Merkel should be arrested. I mean, they did this on purpose. They advertised it. They don't even check the passports of these people. When they're known terrorists, they let them run around. People say, it's all false flag. I thought you were about false flags, Alex. There's different types of false flags. It is a false flag to open the gate up. Again, if I breed black widow spiders in my basement and go into your house during the day and dump them in your bed, they're going to go up under the sheets and stuff. And when you get in, you're going to get bit. Now, does the black widow take orders from me? No. It's like fire. If I light your house on fire, it's not taking orders from me, but I did it. And so they're doing it. And I sit here. I mean, I'm not bragging, but I mean, when I've gotten involved just to test it, I know how to make money in the stock market basically almost all the time because I know how real news and information works. and real markets. General public can't figure it out. Even stockbrokers can't. Soros can because he's an insider. Well, I'm an insider from the outside. I know how they operate. It's like I've got eyeballs and other people don't. And I'm on a power trip. I've had the elite over and over again go, look, they're animals. You can't help the public. They're going to tear you apart. You might as well join us. Well, I can't be part of brainwashing people and putting poison in the water so they're even dumber so you can manage them. I just, I'm not putting my soul on the line. But then I'm stuck between the piranha-like public and then I'm stuck with these horrible vampire elites. And it's just like, I just want to go to find some new country or new place to get away from this stuff, man. It is. And the ignorance of the general public when they just believe, excuse me, I had a whole opinion during the break. Well, you know, they just believe their own garbage. It's so frustrating. And then those that are evil, that are smarter, but not spiritually smart, they're smart intellectually. They're smart like a lizard, you know, very coldly, to prey on people. You don't just prey on someone because they're smarter than you. You don't just go rob a Down syndrome man because you can. Oh, look, he's retarded. Let's go beat him up and rob him. You know, it's I just don't get it. It's so predatory. And we need to be not predators, but as I've said many times, sheepdogs. And that's not from the movie. I've been using sheepdog for 20 years on air. That's a saying around the country. I'm not a wolf. I'm a sheepdog. Where you should really want to attack wolves. And you should really want to go after them. And that just men aren't doing that. They put on their football jerseys. They suck their thumbs. And they act tough to each other. And that's what men do. And so great, you're not a man, you're not alive, you're pretending to be, and that's why you're so unhappy. I appreciate your call. Great points, Chris. You know, there's got to be some way to change this because, look, it's not all controlled. It is controlled, but the globalists are delusional. They're very smart, and they opportunistically jump on any new crisis that's there or exacerbate or create them. But they say, oh, the world's going to collapse, and we're going to consolidate control. But it's not just that they're collapsing it. It is collapsing because they don't want to manage things. They don't want to create prosperity. They want to be greedy. So it is collapsing. And they have a cosmology that, oh, we're geniuses. We're doing the controlled collapse. But notice the controlled collapse isn't going that way. It's like Bracken. Matt Bracken says, you can't ride the tiger like you think you are. You can't ride 10 or 15 tigers. Smart elites before weren't perfect, but they didn't do things that were this reckless. They had common decency because they knew it would blow back on them. Like, don't target women and children because you don't want yours targeted. That's what barbarians do. And we are not cultured anymore. You grow up, you think like people being cultured is like wimpy. No, it's not. It's reserve because you're a wild animal. And the veneer of civilization is peeling off right now, ladies and gentlemen. And I can tell you, whether it's this year or 5 years from now or 10 years, we're trying to hold the collapse here, but the gate is on fire. The enemy's coming through, and there's all these trendies going, where's the crisis? Where's the world government? As it's all being announced, as people are starving, 50 million a year. It was 15 million a year just a decade ago. I mean, it's crazy, folks. All hell's breaking loose because goodness is going out of the world in the ruling class. Our cynicalness as a people, our laziness is empowering this. And I will tell you, we are going to be judged just like the 55 million babies that have been aborted. You can make excuses for it, and Lord knows I've been involved in it before I grew up. I'm not on some high horse, but when you won't recognize evil and when you won't admit it's going on, it's going to do more than bite you in the butt. And I can feel God's judgment coming down. I mean, talk about God-fearing. It means you can feel the presence of God. It's all around us. And I just, it's like, in a way, I'm like, well, I love my family and everything, but God, you know best. Go ahead and do it. You want to have a big nuclear war, have the ocean die, see 3-4 billion people starve to death in a couple months? Nobody's going to care about your 50 genders then. And I think, you know, all these arrogant elites, they're going to die in the midst of it. So, you know what? I don't blame God. I hope we change things. But, you know what? God needs to take us all out. Go ahead. people running things are looking for trouble. Just like a psychopath that's killed 20, 30 people, they start getting real reckless. They start getting wanting to get caught. And we got people like that running the show. So, okay. We have Eric Holder confronted. It's on Infowars.com. Would you have prosecuted Hillary? Infowars confronts Eric Holder. It's a short clip. Here it is.
Mr. Holder, would you have prosecuted Hillary? No, he would have run from it just like that. Okay. David Knight from Infowars.com.
Well, look at the look on Holder's face. It's all funny. At least they asked the question. I would just continue harrying him. Like I did to Turd Blossom. That's the real name that Bush called. Reportedly, Karl Rove didn't like me and called Turd Blossom. So he's ignoring me. He says he's history's actor. You know, he's God. And so, you know, I was going to question him. Let's play that clip one more time.
Mr. Holder, would you have prosecuted Hillary?
Of course, you couldn't hear him because he ran off.
No, he would have run from it just like that. Okay. David Knight from Infowars.com.
So David couldn't hear him. But there went Holder. Boom. Boy, don't talk about prosecuting people. Holder presides over the law firm that you've got to have certify your taxes or your offshore deal, kind of like Arthur Anderson was the accounting firm, where all these former FBI directors and former Justice Department directors and others, is a very select group, they rule that you can do whatever you want and steal whatever amount of money you want, and then they go back to that law firm and make $50 million a year apiece, literally. But notice Holder's surrounded by a bunch of black people. Because he cares about black people. That's why he lives in a rich white neighborhood and lets weapons be sold to third world dictators. It's all crap. It's camouflage. Cover. He told the media we need to brainwash the American public against guns. I mean, it's just like we're ruled by these pieces of crap. All right, let's go to who's been holding the longest now. Isaac in Texas, then James. And
it's not just our water we need to filter. It's not just our food that needs to be clean. It's the air we're breathing, especially for.
They're getting pretty wild.
I'll say this, man. I never thought I'd live to see this day or these days that we're living in. I mean, where you lose friends that you've had for years. Because they ask one question, who are you voting for Hillary? And last night I was finishing up some work and I had your InfoWars window open, listening. And she chimes in, and a longtime friend, and she asked me the question. I guess, you know, the DNC, I couldn't watch it, by the way. I wanted to make a statement on that. That was just so much anti-gun propaganda to me. I heard about 10 minutes of it.
Sure. So a holier than thou person being manipulated calls you up and to try to bully you into voting for Hillary.
Exactly. And she asked me a simple question. She said, are you voting for Hillary? I said, you know, honestly, Trump is where I'm at. And, you know, I have my reasons. And, you know, she went off. She called me an idiot, and I won't get into it. I'll just say my message, my last message was, and this is someone I've known for years, and we've never had a disagreement. I didn't even say I was voting for Trump.
No, just go ahead and tell me what happened.
Well, you know, I told her this. I said, look, if you're gonna side with someone who has, had classified information in a you know, server in a basement, and who's basically,
the server thing was always a red herring. She stole the nomination. I mean, did this dingbat you were talking to care about that?
You know what her response to that was? That's when she responded that I was an idiot. That was where I ended it. And I just, you know, it's her right to believe that. I feel bad.
Well, brother, here's the deal. Does this woman live in Texas?
Yes, sir.
She's probably too stupid to know it's going to go completely for Trump. They wouldn't even dare steal that And so it doesn't even matter. You know, people should chill vote just for the general overall count. There's other elections. But again, you're talking to mental midgets who probably believe in Nigerian emails. You know, I've told you, I've had multiple people in the last 20 years, it's been going on that long, stop associating with me when they started announcing that they were about to get $1 million from Prince Abubu. One time the guy actually had the name Prince Abubu. And I explained, once you give them 5,000, you know, you don't get the 100,000, and then they're going to want 10,000, and then it's going to be $1 million you're getting. And then finally, if you just give us 5,000 more, Prince Abubu will speak to you. Or Prince Abubu will be landing at the airport. You go to the airport, Prince Abubu isn't there. But you're so crestfallen, you're so excited that Prince Abubu cares about you that you give Nigerian scam artists, and that's just one country that does it, $15,000. I went out one night with a well-known producer and TV individual. I'll sleep with that. I don't know why I'm telling that story. I'll tell the story. I went out with Mike Judge to hear some really great rockabilly music in Far East Austin at what was a black bar. And it was just a whole mixed bar, nice people, nice place, and I'm out there. And everybody goes, oh, my God, Prince Wagugu Zabubu or whatever's going to arrive. And it's like this old Cadillac pulls up. He's got these African outfits. And half the folks are bowing down and worshiping him. And, of course, it was a total scam. And then pretty soon I heard he was there raising money for something in Nigeria. And, I mean, good for them. Wear a lion hat or whatever everybody bows down to you. I mean, it's just, look, it's the same thing with Hillary, okay? It's a Nigerian email scam. And usually with Republicans it would be, too. That's why I didn't support McCain or Obama in 2008. Because I knew how bad McCain was. But with this, there's a real choice. So I appreciate your call, Isaac. I'm sorry. But she's smoking the Nigerian email scam. And what happens is, once somebody's been conned, a loser, who's never faced reality, a victim, they always blame whoever warns them. But if they get involved in a con, they won't admit that they are a victim. See, victimology people never blame those that are really victimizing them. They always blame the fantasy. They live in fantasy land. They want to believe they're getting $1 million from Prince Abubu or Prince Daktuk Blackbu or whatever the stupid name is they make up. And they live in a fantasy land, a pageant. I was talking to this lawyer I know who does a lot of divorce cases, and he said, listen, I know cases with women where they go to court 30, 40 times, losing every time, doing crazy stuff because they like to boss lawyers around and just have attention and just have people in the court and just get off on it. There's people that go in and get all these weird medical procedures just because they like the attention. It just, there's a lot of craziness, man. And the world's gotten so soft, people don't have to live in the real world. And the ruling class have all this industry and all this power at their disposal. So they just want to get everybody anesthetized with food and drugs and media while they control the future. And that's why they're so disconnected and so arrogant, because they know this is all just a matrix. It's all just, you know, it's a Nigerian scam. I knew a talk show host who I heard on air. I heard, have you heard this talk show host on GCN like 14, 15 years ago, is saying that they've been contacted by the Nigerians and they're going to give him $10 million or whatever it was, and he's going to, you know, all he's got to do is make a small investment, and it's really come through. The Nigerian government wants to help him. And I called the guy, and I said, it's a scam, bro. And he went on air and said that I was full of it. And a few weeks later, when he got ripped off, he said I had messed up the deal with the Nigerian government. There was no deal with the Nigerian government. It's like in Glenn Leary, Glenn Ross. Is that how you pronounce it? It's a great movie. I'm going from Glenn Leary, Glenn Ross. Teleprompter free. And then they're pressuring this guy to make a sale. And he finally goes to the people that are delusional, crazy people. And they buy the, you know, the land shares. And, of course, the guy finds out that's the case and commits suicide. And people under pressure will become delusional. You're a man in the desert. A mirage looks like water. You want to believe it's water because you're so darn thirsty. And look, doesn't mean I don't see mirages sometimes too, but compared to the general public, it's so sad. And I you know, they tell me I'm in the wrong business. They say, you know, you ought to just go with the system. I just, let me tell you, I've been around globalists. I've been around them. They are the most fake, empty, unhappy people in the world. And as bad as some of the general public is, bleary-eyed and snot-nosed, they are a lot better than the globals. We're going to come back the final hour of the 28-hour transmission with Robert from Minnesota, Gwen in Louisiana, and many others. Stay with us. Let's go ahead and talk to Robert in Minnesota. Thanks for holding, Robert, then Gwen and others. Okay, Robert, appreciate your call. Let's go ahead and go to, we're going to go to Louisiana. We're going to go to Gwen. Gwen, you're on the air.
Hi there, Alex. How are you?
I am good. Well, thank you for calling and holding patiently.
Oh, no problem. It's an honor to talk to you. And first and foremost, I want to express my sincere appreciation to you and your entire crew for the phenomenal job y'all are doing. It's such a honor to be able to hear somebody speak the truth, especially with the censorship.
Well, it's an honor to fight for our lives, sweetheart. That's all we're doing, but thank you.
Well, we pray for you, and we thank you for all the sacrifice we know you're making. One point I wanted to bring up, and you kind of touched on it, is the power, I mean, with all the demonic forces that are behind the Hillary forces and the DNC and the globalists, I think right now, in addition to speaking up like we're doing and fighting the good fight, I think we can't diminish the power of prayer.
I agree.
And you've mentioned it, and I think at this point, you know, God... You're right when you say that he has every right to just blow us away because of the things we've done. The country has fallen so far. I wouldn't blame him either. But we also, I mean, you know, if you remember in like the 20s and 30s and 40s when things really got weak and bad for our country, people would flock to churches and pray for God's intercession and help. And I wish so much that I would see people realize that God's going to be the answer to all these evil things going on, and I wish more people would realize that. And
no, their God is being like 200-pound toddlers bitching about how everything's given to them free.
Exactly, and if people would just, you know, enlighten themselves and realize, I have a 27-year-old daughter who is such a fan of yours. She's got all your T-shirts. And
thank you.
I'll be honest with you. She is so disheartened when she talks to her peers at how just dumbed down they are, and I'm so proud of her for being so on top of things, and it's just such a sad state when you see our youth being so disillusioned and buying into the crap.
Well, your daughter's a chip off the old block, and that's why she's awake, and you know, it's up to her just to forcefully not even make it be a debate or like kind of halfway apologize when you talk to somebody politically. I just say, listen, you've been conned. This country's in crisis. You're under mind control. You need to break out of it. Ma'am, great to hear from you, Gwen. Thanks for holding. We're going to come back and talk to James in Colorado, Gina in Maryland, Jason in New York, and Rob in New York. Anthony will be with us. I'm going to read a few of these famous passages, and then I'm going to punch out. And Anthony Gucciardi, our health news director, is going to take us across the finish line. This world and the spirit of this world is not going to replenish you. Our source, God, will. You're not going to get that at one of these whorehouse churches run by incarnate demons. Let me tell you, folks, I am a very sensitive person. In these big mega churches, I've never felt so much evil. Not in the Roman Colosseum, not a Bohemian Grove. Those are evil, 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 evil people. Who the world is set up over these churches, and they know exactly what they're doing. The only place I get the same creeps is being around Democratic Party leaders. And I did get creeped out being around old Republican Party leaders. I didn't get any of that around Donald Trump. I'm just going to leave it at that. My spider sense didn't pick up anything but somebody who's super dominant, super aggressive, thinks he's smarter than everybody, probably is, and doesn't want to screw America over and wants wealth and prosperity. He's not a eugenicist. He doesn't want to screw everybody over. That's Donald Trump. Anthony, I'm going to take a few final calls here and hand the baton to you, but I just want to thank the listeners, thank the viewers. I want to thank everybody for making InfoWars what it is, the great crew we've got, the films, the reports, the news, the radio, the articles, just the memes. We're just dominating exponentially despite all the Google censorship and all the Twitter and Facebook censorship, but it's getting serious. I mean, if there were ever any doubts about the nature of the globalist, Anthony, I think it's very clear.
It's really inspiring, and I was going to talk about it today. The establishment is kind of like the Rio 2016 Olympics, the facade. So, you know, you look at like the corpses washing up on the beaches. They said, just close your mouth to the swimmers in the water because the water's so contaminated and disgusting. And they said it's like swimming in a pool of feces, right? And we get to that. Today we have like fighter jets colliding over it because the planning is bad. But then they say, you can't tweet about it. You can't tweet about the Olympics.
That's
if you're
a test
not a
globally of the new TPP censorship where just they own all the words. Well, know what? We're going to tweet that the Rio Olympics are nothing but a giant latrine. Yeah. The Rio Olympics are a diseased, filthy, collapsed hell.
And it's just like the system. It tells you that it's going to take care of you. You're only allowed to do what it tells you to do. But meanwhile, it's like a massive, disgusting wart on the side of society, the establishment system.
Well, let's look at that water they tell folks to swim in. I mean, that looks like chocolate milk.
Oh, it looks great.
So much feces.
And the scientists talking about it, they said it would actually be like swimming in a pool of feces.
But hey, there's a dead body, kind of like, you know, like matzo balls floating around in it. I mean, what's wrong with that?
It's good for you.
Why are you being a conspiracy theorist?
Well, Florida's going to raise the toxic limit in water, in all of the water supply. So
they did that with radiation, yeah. I mean, yeah. The problem, radiation goes up a couple 100%, just raises.
Yesterday they said that they're going to change the levels for toxic contaminants in the water because they want to raise the acceptable limits. So it's just like,
why are you
Olympics.
Being racist against radiation?
I am being racist against
radiation.
In fact,
you know, some leftist groups that now want nuclear power plants everywhere, they flipped. They're saying that there's radiation phobia.
Sounds like a real thing. I think there's toxic chemical phobia. I think there's oppression phobia. I think there's tyranny phobia. I think there's injustice phobia. There's a lot of phobias out there. I have a lot of them, actually. I've been diagnosed with most of those I just listed. So,
all right. Well, all I can say is we've got some of the biggest specials we've ever run. I want to thank you all for your support. We can't run all of these another day or two. We're going to run some of them a little bit longer, but it's going to be ending tomorrow. 40% off Brain Force, the nootropic. I mean, Anthony, just spend a few minutes on Brain Force. This has got one compound, at least, in it that's prescription in Europe. It's just the building blocks of the brain. It's amazing.
So there's 1,019 reviews on the Brain Force page on InfoWars Life. And when I go out to print some of these reviews to read on air, it's endless five-star reviews. There's actually hundreds of them. I almost want to say near 1,000. If you look at the number, the average is 4.6. It teeters around 4.6, 4.8. InfoWars is literally about, clearly, the best products. Brain Force to me is it's beyond an energy drink. It's beyond something that you
Everyone
buy.
Else, we had a nutraceutical company here 2 weeks ago. They go, Alex, we marked things up 5 times. They're wanting to sell me stuff. And it was good stuff. And I said, no. Our markup's 100%, not 700. Theirs was 500.
And we don't sleep. Look, remember that one guy we had on, the Natural Products Insider guy? They sweep stuff off the floor that fell off the conveyor belt, the herbs, in some of these major companies.
The reason we sell out a lot of times is if something's got multi-ingredients, like a DNA force or a brain force, we got to wait months and months till we finally get batches that are California compliant, which is almost impossible to make it. That's why we sell out all the time.
The manufacturer tests it, and then we independently test every
single
thing.
They can still just ship it out. I mean, quite frankly, the California standard is pure bull, but we want to be neurotic about it.
Yeah, exactly. But Brain Force, it does have an ingredient or two that are prescription in Europe, depending on how you want to look at it. One is controlled, one is a prescription. So the key, though, is that it's not like coffee where you're going to be all jittery and caffeinated. These are the natural compounds that actually work synergistically in the brain to make you feel more alert and more focused. For me, so it's not,
the best
it's
stimulant I've ever taken. I don't like stimulants other than like coffee and stuff and tea, but I will tell you, if you're really exhausted and take it, you'll be wide awake, but it does make me aggressive.
Yeah. Well, the alpha GPC and the hyperzine and the phosphatidylserine, those are all things. And by the way, the phosphatidylserine, it's been told by our manufacturer that they are looking into turning that into more towards, the FDA is looking at some companies trying to make that a pharmaceutical drug or a part of pharmaceutical drugs. So we might not even be able to have it in about 6 months. But the phosphatidylserine, which is expensive, it's hard to get. That is with the hyperzine A and alpha GPC, is not caffeine. It's not even yerba mate extract. It works to get the brain where it needs to be and works with different chemicals and choline and all of that to make you more focused, as opposed to just the yerba mate extract, which is awesome. And I drink yerba mate, but I take Brain Force instead. It keeps you focused, it's alert, but it's not just a bzzz energy. It's actually kind of a calm focus thing, but it will wake you up.
If you're not up for 2 days like Rob did.
If you're not up for 2 days like Rob do, the wet cat.
Who has become the Brain Force goblin.
Yes. It's an honorary title.
He stayed like four or five a couple nights in a row, like after midnight, having a little bit of fun with the crew. And I'm sitting there like out in the sun, like 8 o'clock. It's already, he's like, ah. You know, I keep worrying, rainforest. I was like, no, you're going to bed now. But, yeah, it's. I'm teasing Rob. I love Rob. He's a sweetheart. But seriously, like the good halogen, the pure iodine we have that nobody else has, X2. Three weeks to 4 weeks into it, you're probably going to detox. I did. A bunch of oil is going to come out of your skin. At least it did for me. Group warned me, and I felt like crap about 5 days. But then it was like, I liken it when you're carrying your kid up, you know, a hill or something, you know, a mile, when you're a four-year-old, and once you get there, you take the kid off your shoulders, feels like you're flying. After a month on X2, it was just like, whew, it was like I woke up, and it was like I was 18. And it's because I was deficient in iodine, folks, which they admit caused a 15-point IQ increase when the Fed started putting it in the salt in the mid-20s. Of course, now they've taken it out of the salt. So it's got a 4.8 review, 1,767 reviews on third-party power review site. I mean, that's a big deal, Anthony.
No, it's serious. I mean, what do you think happens when you put the good halogen in the body when you're bombarded with the bad halogens?
No, but they've had articles saying we're quacks. You don't even need iodine, Anthony.
No, you're quacks. And you know what's funny about some of those articles, too? It's not even that they're attacking us. They just go ahead and say the entire system that relies on natural medicine.
And they claim fluoride's not good for your thyroid.
Yeah, and then they say, and the FDA says you only need this much percentage of iodine a day. Oh, wow, the standards to where you just don't drop over and die. It's like vitamin C. It's like you only need 100% RDA vitamin C, which is barely just enough to not
You only
get
need
scurvy.
One bite of an apple a day.
Yeah.
So your teeth won't all fall out.
Exactly. But those are high quality standards. No, actually, you know what? I want to go beyond to where I'm just not about to die. I kind of want to feel optimally healthy. But if I follow the FDA stuff, I'd probably maybe not totally.
Now forget Linus Pauling, won two Nobel Prizes for science, saying that mega doses of vitamin C were the key there. I mean, just
look. And there's a reason rickets are back in the United States.
Absolutely, and then you go to the doctors, and they won't tell people the reason their legs are being chopped off, or the reason they can't fight infections, because these people never eat leafy vegetables.
It's true. They don't take vitamins. They don't know any of it. And then we're bad.
Wait. We're skip this break. I'm going to call. You're a conspiracy theorist. You're claiming that I need vitamin C. I'm going to call the FDA. You're claiming.
And you should call.
Wait a minute. Are you going to claim I need oxygen next?
I'm going to claim you need thousands of percentages higher vitamin C and oxygen. And I think it's actually good. And I think iodine's good.
You're claiming if I go down 100 feet under the water, I can't just breathe water.
You could. You could try it.
It works for about 30 seconds.
I hear it feels pretty good after a little while, actually.
That's such a good way to go.
Yeah. So I guess maybe that is my recommendation.
Are you ashamed to be involved with a snake oil salesman that claims we need oxygen?
You know, not only do you claim we need oxygen, you claim we need vitamins. And not even just oxygen, actually. Water, which, by the way, in Europe, you can't say water cures
dehydration.
You cannot say that. Companies have been attacked over that. Okay? That is a claim. So we're not going to say it on air here. We're not going
to
say
absolutely. You do not need water to live. You do not need oxygen. In fact, you don't need brain force. You don't need DNA force. That's equivalent to what 500 cartons of blueberries in it. You know the next level of vitamin C, a bio PQQ. You don't need a planet to live on. In fact, we never existed.
It's all facts. This is all real life.
I'm not being sarcastic. You know, Reuters says it's a conspiracy theory if you even discuss martial law in Turkey. I'm not kidding.
There's a piece right here about that, actually. Where is it? They just shut down 130 media outlets and dismissed 1,600 military personnel. That's a conspiracy theory, too.
China just completely declared martial law over media. No reporting online allowed, period.
No, that would be bad.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, again,
that's actually the noise that China makes when they initiate the censorship button. There's like a big red button, and it just messes you. You go, yeah. That's the noise
the
nice you
got. Nyeh.
Yes. Nyeh.
He goes, we want a shrubbery. I'm like, oh, here's a shrubbery. I want 14 shrubberies. I want 20 shrubberies. 50 shrubberies.
It's true.
Well, you know, there's another conspiracy that we talk about that the carbon dioxide level is actually lower than it's ever been in the history of the planet. And that's what's causing the deserts to form. And of course, that's an admitted fact, but it doesn't matter. But the UN has said that actually carbon dioxide should be lowered and it's not needed. It's actually a bad guess. Did you know that, Anthony?
There's a lot of conspiracies out there. You know,
that's like saying oxygen needs to be banned. I mean, they're really doing this, folks. Without oxygen, which is a trace gas, bye bye. And without carbon dioxide, bye-bye to the plants who create the oxygen. So bye-bye to everybody. Bye-bye, bye-bye. But FDA says, hey, do not say you need oxygen. So I think everybody, put a noose around your neck, hang it, turn purple. You don't need oxygen. Of course, that'll actually kill you, but it's okay. Go. I'm sorry, Anthony.
You're triggering me right now. I'm going to have to go. I'm going to have to take my mic off live. You're triggering me.
What triggers me is Marilyn Monroe in her prime.
That's triggering me too, actually. There's a lot of triggering going on. Hey, you know what? This is the culmination of a 28-hour broadcast, and we haven't gone crazy yet. And you were here till like 1 a.m. last night.
I'm not a good American, though.
No, you're not.
We're doing important work, though, at 1 a.m.
We were doing important work, actually. It's a lot of important work to be done.
It's not a conspiracy. What's going on?
No. It is a conspiracy. We just created a conspiracy.
I'm just not trading punches anymore.
All right. How's your arm feeling?
Not too good. And Weldon's trying to act like his. He's like, oh, look, I've got a little bruise. Alex. Oh, you're so tough. I'm like, yeah, dude, right. Like, what up? Oh, my God. That was fun, though. Oh, it hurt me. But anyways, I'm back to eighth grade now.
So, just, hey, you only grow up so you can go back to being a child again, right?
Once the man, twice the child.
Yep, there you go.
All right, Anthony, we're going right back to you in a moment. We'll go to these calls. The time has come. The time is now. Marvin K. Mooney, you must go now. James in Colorado, you're on the air. Thanks for holding.
What's up, Alex? It's funny. I actually talked to you during the money bomb. You sent me that $200 gift card. So I did try out your products. They are really, really great.
Thank you, brother. What products do you like specifically?
Brain Force was good. I didn't get the energy that I was hoping from the products, but it was fine because it had this long-term detox effect. I was like Rob, you know, taking four, five at a time. So, you know,
yeah, that's wet cat force.
So I want to talk about Hillary and Bernie supporters because I'm a liberal. So your YouTube cut, I guess, is I'm saying that these people are lazy, sappy hacks at best, and at worst, because they're easily animated. By spirit of violence and craze, that's what they are. You know, they're violent, crazy people. And you can look at Hillary Clinton's emails, like WikiLeaks has hacked, or actually this is unclassified, but she says, quote, the best way to help Israel deal with Iran's nuclear capability is to help people of Syria overthrow the regime of Assad. It's actually one of her emails. You look at Sanders, it's like, just go to Google and listen to what he says, and type in Bernie Sanders scandal or Bernie Sanders flip-flop and just read five pages of all the articles and you'll learn.
Well, Bernie Sanders is a complete fraud and a con man, and is just a total blob. He's like every other communist dirtbag we've ever seen. And, of course, he was there shilling for Hillary the whole time. And, of course, he dropped out. And, of course, he let her steal it. And he's a disgraceful person. And any of his snot-nosed followers that don't admit they were conned are aiding and abetting it, James.
It's just, it's almost amusing, but the fact that they're both such war hawks and there's this fake competition between them, I'm glad that people are seeing Hillary as the thief of all this stuff.
Exactly. She's so unpopular. I can't believe they're going to install her or try to. Have you seen the new Age Skrillex, Carl the Cuck extravaganza video on InfoWars.com?
I have intentionally avoided that. I know it's going to just be over the top.
No, it is a beautiful work of art. And I want to say this seriously. I'm not always gay, but when I am, it's for AIDS Skrillex.
Well, you're going to catch AIDS that way, so be careful.
All right, I appreciate your call, James. I don't think the real person, it's a joke term. I didn't create it, but I do want to invite AIDS Skrillex or whatever his name is and Carl the Cuck. We had Obama phone lady here. I'm offering AIDS Skrillex and Carl the Cuck $5,000 each and all expenses paid to Austin to come here and be in studio. And I think instead of them running and hiding and being all depressed as we've been told they are, which I'm sad, they should come in here and let us deprogram them. I'm ready to do it. I am ready because of my man crush. Okay, that part of the joke is over now. I don't know, Aid Skrillex, can we play some of the animated video from the background for TV viewers? I'm sorry. Anthony, admit we've got a crush on AIDS Skrillex.
No, look, let's be honest, all right? these are two really powerful people and
intellectual giants.
I personally like Carl the Cuck. That's my favorite. You know, Abe Skrillex is good. He's great.
Are you kidding
me? Are you kidding me? His face.
He looks like a weird, skinny Rachel Maddow.
He has such joy in his face.
Such arrogance.
He's like, literally, I would follow him into battle. I would follow him into battle, man. He's like a Braveheart level leader, okay? He's like William Wallace on steroids. Look at his face.
It looks just like him.
Whoever did this is great.
I want to. Oh, my gosh.
The neck fat, too. It's perfect.
Oh, my God. They're talking about how much they hate Western civilization right here.
Yeah.
Oh, I turned it off. I'm sorry.
I would love to have them come here. That would be great. It would be worth every penny of the $5,000 each.
Oh,
it would just be great.
Sold tickets. Jason in New York, you're on the air.
I'm a very, very big fan of the show.
Thank you.
You're brilliant.
No, I'm not.
Very brilliant. Yes, you are. The way you handled Karl Rove, the Young Turks, he was brilliant.
Oh, you're nice.
I do agree with Gwen, the previous caller. You are brilliant and you're very brave. And also, we need to pray for them. Pray for their release from the clutches of evil and sin. It will be like a mountain full of force that even they can't stop. I've got a question. Are we really that powerless, the American people? Are the voices of the American people suddenly of no relevance? Do you remember the film Howard Beale from Network? He wanted 1 million telegrams in the White House. Well, how about 1 million telegrams to the FBI, to the State Department? We can do it. The listeners can do it. Speak your anger.
Well, sure. I think 1 million telegrams have been sent figuratively. I mean, did you see the video? It's on InfoWars. How within a second, less than a second, when he hears, "Would you have prosecuted Hillary?" Eric Holder, the former attorney general, runs like death is at his doorstep.
Well, the FBI, I don't know what they're waiting for, but if they knew they had the full support of the American people, things may just change. Call them up, write them letters. They're there. They answer the phones. But are we that out of line to request for clarity, honesty, diligence on behalf of the U.S. side? We may as well be voting for Prince Abubu, as you mentioned.
True. You're just jealous that I'm getting 1 million from Prince Abubu. You're just jealous, Jason, that you're not the one getting it. Prince Abubu likes me.
You're precisely right. That's right.
I'm going to be somebody now. The prince is coming to meet me.
And when you speak to Hillary Clinton supporters, don't waste time. All they say is, I don't have to answer your questions. How dare you make me wrong? I'm a woman. Don't waste time speaking to them. They're like sheep. They'll wake up eventually, but don't waste time with them.
Great point, sir. Sorry, go ahead.
You're brilliant. Your show is
Stop
brilliant.
It. Stop it. I love you. Look. We're just chronicling reality here, and our rose-colored darkies a little bit thinner than some people's. Some people got a hood over their head. Jason, I know Anthony's going to take more calls from Gina and Christine and Greg. Or is that Christian? My eyes are blurred in the lines. Rob and others. And he's got a bunch of clips he's going to get to and a lot more. What else you got coming up, Anthony Gucciardi?
I've got a lot of news. I've got some interesting stuff. I mean, Merkel says, there's no way that she's going to rule out anything of the migrant policy that after the attacks, just let them all in. It just continues.
You call it migrant. It's not an invasion your own government's orchestrating. And don't forget, the sale's going to end today. There'll still be some sales tomorrow, but the big one has to end because I can't keep offering these prices on some things. 40% off storable food, 40% off Brainforce, 30% off on a whole bunch of other stuff. InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com. 20% off on all the Patriot apparel, Heroes for Prison, Bill Clinton rape shirt, and the money we make goes into waging war against corruption. Great job to the whole crew. Great job to Anthony. 30 minutes left in the nightly news tonight with highlights the last 28 hours. Straight ahead.
I'd say that's some perfectly epic music to bring us into the final frontier here of the InfoWars Sleeping Giant, Operation Sleeping Giant marathon. It's been 28 hours. 28 hours of continuous broadcast. Now, some people back there, the producers, have been here the entire time, as well as many other people in this building. Of about 60 people, I'd say a decent percentage stayed 28 hours the entire time. So that's since yesterday, the beginning of the show at 11 a.m. to now. So it's been a pretty epic ride for me. I slept about 3 hours last night. and came in about 7, or woke up about 7 to do the show. But I will say this, it is an amazing thing to, number one, to even look at the emails that come in and see what people are saying about it. Number two, to think about all the people that are actually just collectively putting their energy into this, something that's meaningful, something that's profound, something that is actually going to do something in the world with purpose, right? As opposed to, you think about, and it's not necessarily a bad thing, but think about all the people that take their energy and they put it into something like fantasy football, right? Doesn't mean you're a terrible person if you're playing fantasy football, but the people that just sit there and they just freak out about getting the right linebacker or whatever, or they go and they watch the sporting events and they just freak out about it. They pump their energy. They yell. I mean, I've been at Super Bowl parties, which... I see the most insane things possible. I see people literally taking as much energy as I have to do this entire program. So I could take the energy that they have screaming at the television for their sports team to win. I could take that amount of energy and do an hour on this show. And I could take that amount of energy and encourage you to do something with actual purpose, which is to support something like Operation Sleeping Giant. I do want to remind you that the specials on InfoWarsStore.com, this is part of a super fundraiser, right? This is the last 30 minutes here. This is it. Operation Sleeping Giant is about to end. There's a countdown on the store. And these are all the specials. We're going to have to pull some of these. We'll try and keep some extended, but, I mean, obviously we're selling out of stuff, and we can't keep the loss leaders up. So we've got 40% off Brain Force, 40% off Silver Bullet, which is colloidal silver, 20% off all the water filters, 20% off all the air filters, 30% off flagship Survival Shield X2, 30% off Super Male Vitality, which I feel like we don't even hit on enough. 30% is a very large amount. It sounds routine when you list it like this, but 30% is a significant portion off of products like Super Male Vitality. 30% off Vitamin Mineral Fusion. And then you've got Liver Shield, Deep Cleanse, Anthroplex, Knockout, Survival Seeds, DNA Force. It's all on InfoWarsStore.com. And you've got about less now, about 20-something, 24 minutes, some change, to be a part of this operation. And a lot of you already have, and I want to thank you. You actually are drastically helping. It's not just pontificating about this up here. You know, it's the real deal. I talked about it this morning. Why not put your energy and a little bit of your funding behind something that actually matters, something where you know you've seen the fruits, you've seen what happens. You don't have to agree with everything, right? I don't agree with everything that certain people say, or they don't agree with everything I say. It doesn't have to correspond like that. But look at the fruits. Look at what's actually happening. Look at the difference between this program, the number one radio internet talk show program, and also one of the biggest top 10 in the United States. Look at what it's doing versus the others. Look at what it's doing versus when you turn on your television, you flip through the channels. It's doing a lot of good and a lot of difference, because we're not beholden to these corporations. We're not going to follow the Rio protocol. Here we have this article. The Olympic Committee wants to ban non-sponsor brands from tweeting about the games. So see, we're not beholden like Coca-Cola to this ridiculousness. So I want to bring this up. We've talked about this before, but it's just so absurd. Brands that haven't paid millions of dollars to the group behind the upcoming Summer Olympics will need to watch their step on Twitter in the coming weeks. The International Olympic Committee is threatening legal action against any non-sponsor brands that dare to tweet about the games or any of its associated trademarks, according to a letter obtained by ESPN. Now, Alex talked about this earlier. I wanted to live tweet something about the Olympics. I think we should put out a tweet on the Alex Jones page about the Rio 2016 absurd censorship. Threatening to, I don't know, sue? What are you going to do? What are you going to do if we tweet about Rio 2016? Because, oh, you could say, well, they mean big brands. What does a brand mean? Doesn't mean anything. I'm a brand. InfoWars is a brand. This camera I'm using is a type of brand. Everything's a brand. It's absurd. Oh, no brands are allowed to tweet about us. Well, gee, why do you think they don't want you to tweet about them? Oh, this is because of endless articles like this. Two Brazilian fighter jets collide during a security exercise for the Olympics. Just over and over again. We showed earlier the police and fire with a sign saying, do not enter here. We're not paid enough. You're not safe. Then today, Two Brazilian fighter jets collided off the coast of Rio de Janeiro while on a training exercise designed to hone protection for the city's upcoming Olympic Games. That's safety right there. The Brazilian Navy issued a statement after the collision on Tuesday saying that one of the pilots managed to land his plane safely, but the other crashed into the sea. A massive search began for the pilot, second pilot, and continued through the night and into Wednesday morning. It's actually sad for the pilot. And then, you know, you had the articles about there's bodies washing up on the beach and stuff. And why do I belabor the 2016 Olympics, Rio Olympics? Because, as I mentioned a little bit earlier, it is such a perfect parallel to everything else that's going on. Where, just like the DNC, it's a total crap show. It's a total, like, they're like hiring actors to fill seats because all the Bernie supporters left because they won't buy into Hillary. And then they're just like, it's fine. It's amazing. Look over there. There's smoke and fire. And they're like having sprinklers. Like, look, there's fireworks. Everything's like burning down. Everyone's running and screaming. MSNBC is doing live shows. And there's protesters behind. They're actually real liberals that support Bernie. And they're screaming and saying, no Hillary. It's BS. And they're like, everything's fine. Ha ha. And they're like, smile and have the representatives just ignore the people like it's like peasants riding in the background or something. So the Rio 2016 Olympics kind of like that. It's kind of like how the establishment system, how the establishment bought and paid for politicians are always like, everything's great. Like Obama's speech last night, 70% of the country doesn't like the direction of the U.S. And which I've talked about multiple times. I like how Trump tweeted it also, but they don't like the direction of the U.S. And Obama goes on. He's like, everyone loves this. Everything. Everyone agrees that we're going in the right direction. Millions of people are so happy with what we've done with this country. It's like, no, they're not. Not at all. Is this the Rio 2016 Olympics? Where, number one, they put out the press photos that look beautiful and everything's great. Number two, you're not allowed to talk about it. And then number three, the truth is it's a gaping flesh wound. But it's okay. Everything's fine. Don't worry about it. And then you have Turkey. Turkey orders shutdown of over 130 media outlets, dismisses 1,600 military personnel. So Turkish authorities ordered the closure of more than 130 media outlets on Wednesday. Can you imagine that, by the way? Just imagine closing 130 media outlets. In a crackdown following July's failed coup, Reuters reported, citing CNN Turk, some 1,600 military personnel were also sacked in the Turkish government's latest move. So I kind of see similar things with the generals and everything being ousted, but imagine descending into a regime in which 130 media outlets can be closed down. And the reason we talk about this, and we're going to talk about another article about the United Arab Emirates, is because it's important to take your mindset. Okay, you're sitting right now maybe in the car or at home or at work or whatever. Chances are, if you're listening in the United States or a developed country, that you might be in a similar situation that I am. You might be sitting here at this desk. You might be in the cool air conditioning. I've got lights. I've got computer screens. I've got pretty much a pretty good environment right here, right? Now, meanwhile, we can't see anything that's an immediate threat, presumably, right? There's nothing bad happening here. I could just sit here for a while. But there's a detachment, because when we're just fat and happy and we can see the TVs in the background, like I can see the news TVs in there. I can see, you know, ads for pharmaceutical drugs or whatever to make me happy and Prozac and whatever it is. I can see all those things. I can see football. I can look up news here. I can look up silly websites. I can go on Reddit all day. And it's hard for me in that state to actually get in the mindset that, number one, there's real things that are a threat in this world that we need to care about. And number two, not everyone is in your position. And so the issue here is also things like this. If you get caught using a VPN in the United Arab Emirates, you will face fines of up to $545,000. So Turkey's shutting the media companies down. United Emirates fining people. I mean, there's no freedoms in many of these countries. And then we're sitting here worried about getting triggered by Twitter. Also, the producer just reminded me, we do have a boiled down of Billy Corgan from last night, who was on the show for the Operation Sleeping Giant. And it boiled it down to all of, I guess, the key points, because there was a lot of really interesting stuff. So I want to go ahead and play that, and then we'll be back with some more news. So let's give that up.
How do you find your inner voice? How do you understand or really connect with what that true guidance is if we haven't even been able to connect with that inner voice for such a long time? How do you even begin that journey?
Well, that's a really difficult question. Let me take one step back because obviously the DNC is going on right now, and they have their own version of this. So this is not a political statement as much as an observation from the standpoint of an entertainer. You've had the DNC now on for 3 days, and you've literally had for 3 days not one mention of the scandal. Let's say from the stage, because obviously there's a lot going on around the event. But from the stage, you had no mention of the WikiLeaks hacking. You've had no mention of Hillary being investigated by the Justice Department, all that, and obviously that was cleared, controversially. So, what I'm trying to say, and the reason I'm bringing this up, and I'm not trying to make a political point, is people are literally sitting in a conference room going, well, we can't talk about that, and we definitely can't talk about that. And if you're going to bring that up, you got to, it's a conscious manipulation.
Mm-hmm.
Now, a person who's on that side of the political aisle would say, well, they don't have to talk about those things. But my point is why wouldn't they talk about those things? Why doesn't Hillary stand up and say, you checked out all my stuff and you came after me and you found nothing? The point is they want to avoid those subjects because they want to turn the page. They want to move on to a different psychological profile. That's entertainment. That is not, that's not nothing to do with the human condition. The natural human response, when you're accused of something, if you believe you're innocent, is to stand there and say, hey, by the way, this is my opinion of what happened. I'm going to tell you the truth, and then I'm going to move forward. You hear Alex do it all the time in the air, where he's accused of things by other people. He will go into a massive explanation of, this is the way I think, this is the way I feel. That is the natural human response to accusation. It's not to propagandize and pretend like nothing's going on. That's entertainment. As far as how do you locate your center, as redundant as it sounds, you must actually look at the world you're living in and make a correct assumption based on your own ideological beliefs, spiritual perspectives, and make a read like a quarterback on the field and look and say, these are my people. These are the people I trust. These are the people I don't trust. These are the people I'm going to follow. And one argument I would make that's sort of an extension of the idea, because obviously race and politics is a very controversial subject at this time in our country's history, as it has been before. I would call it a new tribalism, where people are going to form into new tribes of consciousness and belief systems and interrelate sort of beyond race. And maybe that's part of our human evolution, is that we must, when people say in a very kind of utopian way, we must get beyond people's race, color, creed, and all that stuff. I agree with that as a sort of a natural liberal, but maybe the evolutionary point on that is, you're going to find like-minded people or like-souled people who see the world the way you do, so that you can compare notes and say, yeah, this is the way I feel. And as you said in my introduction, you and I do that sometimes. We will sit and text and talk about, well, what's your perspective? And then you give me your perspective. I think that's what you're going to see more and more, and that's where technology can be an aid to us, because we can kind of in real time share in almost like a different kind of hive mind, bigger sets of information. And that's where InfoWars is very much part of that other tipping point in getting into a bigger hive mind of, what are we actually looking at here when we look at these social, political, spiritual, religious systems, that's the better word, that are basically propagandizing what we're actually looking at and what we're actually experiencing.
So do you think technology, obviously it's super important because this is, how we're able to reach the masses out there, but they control these systems at the moment. They've got people corralled into these internet ghettos and they can shut them down at any time. We've got the internet kill switch. Mm-hmm. So is the internet, obviously it is a mechanism that is helping with this global awakening, but is that it? Or are humans going to evolve on our own to the point? I mean, what do you think? Are we in this matrix, or are we sort of these organic beings, God sort of experiencing itself out here and kind of a warning to not get trapped inside of the internet that they're wanting us to be connected to all the time?
Hmm. Well, taking that in kind of an interesting route, Pete Townsend in around 1971 was writing a kind of a thing called the Lifehouse Project, which sort of pre-staged the idea of sort of spiritual communication vis-a-vis through technology, almost talking about the internet before the internet. And he didn't finish the project, and then many of those songs became famous songs and you know, Won't Get Fooled Again and all this type of stuff. The reason I point this out is that ultimately, from a spiritual and avatar perspective, communication doesn't need technology. We can communicate with the stars or God within at any given time. We don't need Twitter or Facebook to help us do that. But there is a spiritual component to technology in the way that people are sharing in real time. And that was, of course, the great promise when something like Twitter kicked in. Hey, we can all kind of comment and interrelate and find common ground or common belief as an event is unfolding. You saw it during the, you know, what they called the Arab Spring or whatever. Mm-hmm. There was this sort of idea of in-the-moment reportage where everybody was a citizen journalist and taking pictures, and it all felt very refreshing. But what we see now is these systems are being used to actually control, neuter, and shape those thoughts in real time. And I could precisely see it not only on InfoWars but other sites where everyone is racing to shape the narrative before in essence a narrative sets in. And again, from an observational point of view, why is so much energy being exerted to tell you, oh, nothing to see here, move on?
All right, that's Billy Corgan, a very smart guy, very interesting perspective and points. All right, we'll be right back. I want to remind you, this is the last segment coming up of InfoWars Operation Sleeping Giant. Last chance to support the operation. InfoWarsStore.com. Get 40% off Brain Force, Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver, 40% off storable food. It's all there. Help make the difference. InfoWarsStore.com. Be right back. Final segment. You know, you think about the idea of treating your brain like your stomach. And ideally, unless you really just don't care about your body and maybe you don't care about your brain, you want to have content that is nourishing. It's like fruits and vegetables, right? Like real, actually good stuff, like a smoothie or something mixed in with some junk every now and then. You know, every now and then you're going to eat a bag of chips. Every now and then you're going to drink some soda or whatever. But ideally, a good part of your diet should be healthy, right? That's the same with your mental consumption. So consider that you're actually making a good mental diet choice when you have consumption like listening to this program. When you have consumption like going on the internet and actually going to good websites as opposed to some silly stuff, which is always fine. But you want to try and have a plate of healthy consumption and content every single day. That's what I try and do, and that's kind of the whole point. And, you know, today is, as I mentioned, is the conclusion, this segment. This is the final segment of the Operation Sleeping Giant 28-hour broadcast. And I'm actually really honored to be able to be a part of it, and I'm happy that I was asked to be on the last hour and last segment of this entire 28-hour conclusion. Think about all of the people that are listening right now and listen to 28 hours, including yourself. I mean, just millions and millions of people that helped just spread the links, just pray, whatever it is that they did, even the smallest little things, leave a comment, right? Or they financially supported on InfoWarsStore.com. Whatever it is, it's meaningful, it's powerful, there's a lot of energy behind it, and that is a movement. That is a real movement. And notice, it's kind of like building a building. So you think about the establishment, like you have the establishment building, which is run by Hillary Clinton Realtor Incorporated, right? It's like this massive, like monolithic, huge building, something you'd see out of one of the Judge Dredd movies or something. It's just huge. It's just like all busted up and there's like colonies inside and, you know, it's crazy. And here we are. We're building this building. We're this independent architecture firm. And we've got all these people, these community volunteers, because we can't hire, you know, the crazy establishment people they have to build like their robot towers, but we're building like from the foundation. We got cement down there, and now we're a pretty sizable tower. I mean, it's a pretty sizable tower, and we've got the nice looking tower, like gardens outside, and we've got people moving in and offices and stuff. Like, it's a pretty sizable tower. You look up at the establishment tower and they look at your tower and they're like, how did you build that? That's because when you built something independent of the system, that is the power. It's grassroots. It's because of you. All of this is nothing without you. All of it is nothing. It is you contributing in the most tiny and massive ways. All of the energy contributed to this is what gives it the power to go on. It's like a car with fuel just plowing down the highway at full speed. And that's what this is. It's been a long 28 hours. If you're just tuning in now, it's been a long 28 hours. Like I said, a lot of people back there haven't even slept. And, you know, this article, Merkel rules out migrant policy reversal after attacks. She's talking about they're going to still let in as many migrants and refugees as they want, despite all the attacks and everything from ISIS-related groups. It's funny because it reminds me of how, guess what? This program, we're going to talk about what's actually going on. We're going to talk about how we see it. We're going to talk about the fact that a lot of these are linked up with ISIS, and we're not going to be afraid of political correctness. We're not going to be afraid of the attacks and craziness. Anyway, just want to mention that. This is it. This is the conclusion of Operation Sleeping Giant. I'm Anthony Gucciardi. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for being a part of it. It's up at Infowars.com/giant. Share it with your friends. Infowarsstore.com to get the specials before they run out. 40% off Brainforce. Thank you so much. Even if you don't buy anything, you are amazing, and you're the reason this is all happening. God bless.